morning to you. Welcome to the Sewing Quarter. Now, coming up this morning, we have lots of goodies for you. So we've got our simple spring kimono at 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, so organised with a lovely caravan. At 10 o'clock, we've got a fabulous reversible jacket. And at 11 a.m., yes, he's back, our Bonny Bunny Softies, those big-eared bunnies, they're back. They've sold out twice before, but we've brought them back in this time, three different colourways. Oh, yes. Do you want to have a look? Here he is. Where is he? Here he is. Yay! That's your sneak preview. If you have previously missed out on the bunnies, maybe you've watched them on repeat and you know, therefore, that they sell out generally very, very quickly. We've brought them back. More stock, more colours coming up at 11. But this hour is a little bit of a trip down memory lane for me. As a child, my mother used to dress me in a lot of cloth kits and I thought the company had disappeared. And I was absolutely thrilled to see that Cloth Kits is back. And we've got some beautiful, beautiful cloth kits for you. So today we've got this, which is your Cloth Kits kimono pattern. Absolutely stunning. So if you're after something that is simple and stylish to wear, elegant, and you can dress up, dress down, it's entirely up to you how you want to wear this, then we've got three different colourways for you to choose from. So this is what it looks like finished. That's one of our options there. All of these are in Amy Butler fabrics, so you'll know from the vibrancy of the fabrics that it's Amy Butler. She takes, of course, a lot of inspiration from nature, and I think that that is very evident. Let me show you this. This one here, you get enough material and some. Look at that. All, whoa. Hello. All of this material is coming with your pattern. Look at that. This is your poppies. This is your poppy field bundle. ZYGC37. Now that is stylish and vibrant, all in one hit. So you get the pattern and you get 2 meters of your fabric, so that is 2 meters, isn't it? Yeah, so that you can make this kimono. So you choose which one you're going to go for. So we've got that option for you if you're going for the vibrant poppies there. Maybe you want something a little more city chic. Then this is producer Paul's favourite. He's allowed a favourite this morning, but here we go. Let me just waft this around for you so that you can get an idea. Woo! So here we go. This is, again, Amy Butler. So we're talking about 100% cotton here, and this is your organic stripe bundle. Love this. Look at that. It's very unusual, I think, but the colours in there, they just work, don't they? Absolutely gorgeous. So lots of colours that you can pick up if you want a little top to wear underneath your kimono, then lots of different colours so you can really have a splash of colour there, should you wish. So it's in a kit form, so you're going to get all of the fabric that you need and the pattern so you can get going and get sewing. And then the last colour option for you is the one that it's been made out of there. So you can see now the beauty of this fabric. When you look at it closely, it looks from afar like they're flowers, but actually they're butterflies. $35.95 each of these kits. And this is the Take Flight bundle, because obviously it's butterflies rather than flowers, which was pointed out to me by the lovely Jenniffer Taylor. How are you?
Good morning.
Good morning. Are
good
you
morning.
Well?
I am, yeah. No, I noticed it when I was laying the pattern out, and obviously because you want to make sure you got your fabric the right way. I was like, hold on a minute. I thought they were flowers, and they're not. They're little. There's two little butterflies kind of circling each other.
Very pretty. Amy does this very well. The more you look at her fabrics, the more you
pick out detail-wise.
Yeah. Of course, maybe not the stripe, but the other ones. You see, I like the background with the poppies, is that you've actually got you've got patterns within patterns.
It's almost like a wave from that
one,
isn't it?
It's beautiful.
Really,
really beautiful.
Lovely.
Spoilt for choice this morning.
We are spoilt for choice. It was hard having to pick between which fabric I wanted to do it in, but I think the purple
butterflies
and, purple and butterflies won it for me.
So we're taking flight
we're
this morning.
We're taking flight this morning. Oh, you're flying today. I like it.
I do think of you as a kimono kind of a girl.
I do like that boxy jacket, I must admit. And it's a jacket for all occasions, you know, whatever you're doing, whether you're going out and you just want that something just to cover your shoulders up, a little bit chilly, you know, just pop it on. But it's still elegant, isn't it?
Perfect for your holidays.
And yes.
Well, it's going to do everything, isn't it? It's going to do the school run to evenings.
Drinks
change
with
your
the
jewelry,
girls.
Absolutely. Maybe you're out for lunch. Maybe you're a lady who likes to lunch. But it's that spring vibe, isn't it? But it's also going to be perfect to pop in your bag and take on your holidays, or maybe one of those things you want to wear on the plane just to take the chill
off.
It's that
absolutely.
Sort of versatile. You can wear it long sleeves, short sleeves. This is really going to do.
It's a really versatile pattern, like you said. I mean, you could wear just a sort of string vest underneath it if you like, and then you can pop your jacket on over the top, or even wear coupling it up.
String vest?
Well, you know what
like
I mean?
Like Rapsy Nesbitt. Yeah.
I just realised what I said yet. No, I mean, like. Get your string vest
nice.
Out. You don't nice.
Hurries. Yeah.
No, you know what I mean.
It's
like a little strappy top.
Spaghetti strap tops.
What am I going on about? Or a polo neck. Do you know what
you
I mean?
Could, yeah,
you
now
can
Becky's
wear
been
summer
in touch.
Or winter. I bet she has. What have you said, Becky? Come on.
What are we talking about? What's Becky got to say? Do we know? Oh, how easy is it to make? Yes, good question.
Really easy. Really easy. And I want to take some time just to go through the pattern with you, just to show you how easy it is.
Should we just plan out today? Mm-hmm. So this hour, easy kimono.
Easy kimono.
This is your easy level. Now, I know a lot of you are saying, but I want the next level up. Mm-hmm. Well, that is 10 o'clock, because then we've got a reversible jacket for
Ooh,
you then.
That's nice
so taking it to the next level. So if you... You know what? Sometimes you just want an easy, quick make.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
It's going to be beautiful and versatile and functional. Pop a little belt around that. It's another
it's
look,
cute.
Isn't it?
And again, you could lengthen or shorten this. So you could absolutely make it into almost like a dress if you wanted to, and make a little sash, like an Obi-style belt with it. It's a really lovely pattern, and it is really simple. So I want to show you how simple the pattern is.
Go on,
I just
then.
Want to show... Because it's not a lined jacket, I'm going to show you some finishing techniques. So we're going to go through three different ways of finishing your seams.
Okay, because
so
in
got
the
a lot
actual
to dry
pack...
In the pack,
It gives you a very basic way to finish off your seams.
Yeah.
But you're saying, hang on a minute, there are other ways.
Well, no, she alludes to it. Our lovely lady alludes to it. So in your packs, obviously, you've got your main packet there. On the very back here, it's nice to show that, obviously, not only what does it look like from pattern point of view here, or the design of it, but obviously the most important thing is your body measurements here. But because this is such a relaxed jacket, there's actually some further details inside the pattern that I'd like to share with everybody as well.
And this is it, because we've got a narrow fabric here, and so we've given you two metres of that. Okay, so it is absolutely perfect for all these sizes, taken into account, from a UK size 8 up to a UK size 20. We've given you the material for the largest size.
Yep.
So if you're smaller, obviously win-win, because you end up with extra material. Make a belt out of it as well.
An Obi-style belt, lovely. What I really, really liked about these kits are the pattern, like the instructions, are just fab.
Look at this.
Absolutely fab.
That's gorgeous,
really, really
isn't
nice.
It?
Really clear instructions. You're not going to go wrong on this one. But what I really do like about this is that they're recommending you finish your seams. So they either do it like a zigzag stitch, for instance, but they do allude to a French seam. So I was going to show you one of those.
Oh,
I'm
nice.
Also going to show you how to do a mock French.
Faux French?
A faux French.
As I like to call it.
And also a straight seam finish as well.
Okay.
So I'm going to throw three seam finishes in there, so there'll be no raw edges at all on the inside of your
Seamless.
Beautiful, simple jacket.
Nice.
I'm liking your little puns today,
nice.
Lady. But I really wanted just to show you how simple the instructions are. They really are really nice and simple to use. And here as well, so you've got the small, medium and large, and that will indicate to the pattern. So again, going back to the back... All sizes are catered for in this one, so you don't have to, you know, sometimes you have to buy this one, but if you're this size, get another pattern.
No, it's
this
all
size,
in there.
It's all in there.
So if you're between size 8 or 18 in a UK sizing chart, then you are absolutely good to go.
Yep.
With any of the kits that we put together for you, so any of those beautiful different colours, you're entirely good to go. This is really lovely, isn't it? Beautiful.
It's
so
lovely.
You've got the fabrics, you've got a nice, simple pattern, instructions, and of course, Jenniffer here to tell us exactly what to do.
And this is also a nice one as well, because the pattern doesn't come on tissue paper. It's actually paper, which I really, really like, because that means it's going to make it last longer.
Well, you can change the feel and style of this, can't you, by whatever material you choose to go with. We've put it with a lovely lightweight cotton from Amy Butler.
Yeah.
And, of course, that's going to wash and wear so easily, so well. Do wash the material before you start. Get the shrinkage out of the way.
Oh, yes, definitely. Yes. Definitely. I didn't notice any shrinkage in the Amy's because obviously with it being cotton, but that's one of the things I would always suggest, regardless of the brand or mate, always just give it a quick cycle.
Yeah.
And also just to get the starch that sometimes it comes in, just to get that out so you really are working with what you're supposed to be wearing.
So this is what you're getting in each bundle. You will get the cloth kits kit, and this is the flight one. This is the one that we're making it out of today. There are butterflies in there, it looks like flowers. We've got two other options for you. So let's take a look at those as well, because you might want to go, hey, look at this. Oh, this is the poppies. Love the background of the poppies. We'll have a closer look at this one, because I think this one might be my favourite. Actually, this is the funny thing about all of this. I think this one's my favourite. The purple one was your favourite. The Take Flight one was your favourite. And then producer Paul's favourite is this one. It's like the city stripe, almost.
That is funky, though.
She calls it an organic stripe. But I kind of think of it as city chic. I like it.
No, I'm with you on the city chic. Definitely.
Yeah.
It's nice. It's really nice.
What I like about that one is that you can pull different colours from it. So if you want to go, I've got a little bright orange vest top. You could pop that underneath and it would absolutely go.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. Definitely.
You see, I'm not sure if I'm choosing my favourite on which material I like the best and not thinking about actually which one is going to be the most versatile with my wardrobe.
But this is the thing. This is the thing about a kimono. You could wear really simple plain fabrics underneath, but then it's the kimono that gives you that pop of colour. Do you know what I mean? Especially if you struggle with wearing colour very often. Do you know what I mean? Then it's wearing something like a kimono just instantly transforms your look.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean?
Yes. So it's an easy way to do.
Yeah, really simple, easy way to do.
So you've cut the pattern out.
I've already gone ahead and cut the pattern, but I just wanted to show you quickly what that looks like. So this is our front of our kimono, and we have two pieces here, as you can see.
Yeah. So they were just your fabric options.
Our beautiful, lovely fabric options. So this is the front of our kimono there. Mm-hmm. So I've cut that on the fold, so I've got two pieces already pre-cut out, so that's done there. And then the last piece is our back piece, and that's actually done on the fold there. So you can see that I've cut that against the fold, and in the instructions that will tell you what you need to do. So we are going to start constructing our garment.
Can I just... I've got a very, very quick thing to say.
Yes.
Because... the other week when Janice was dressmaking, lovely Janice, we bought this to air, which is your seam right. And it sold out like that.
I love it.
Gone. It's back in stock and we've bought in 10 times the amount because it sold out so quickly.
It's so handy. So
it is. Now, if you haven't seen this before, it's one of these multi-purpose tools that you'll wonder how you ever lived without it. Because each of these gives you a different sort of seam allowance, if you will. So you've got 3/8 of an inch there. Down there, you've got 7/8. Here, you've got an inch marked out. And then under here, 3/4 of an inch, 1/4 of an inch, 1/2 inch, 1 1/8, 5/8, 1/4 of an inch. All those ones that you use day in, day out, that you might want to just check your measurements or do as you're folding over that seam, just check you've got the right size. And then here, Janice said she would buy this for the buttonhole alone.
Yeah.
An inch buttonhole. Clever piece of kit.
What I like about it, because I made one myself really... really rubbishly on a piece of card, but they last 2 seconds, whereas this, lifetime.
Forever.
Lifetime guarantee. So what I would use, this is perfect for your hems, these are. Absolutely perfect. So if I show you what you would do. So let's say that I'm going to be double hemming my kimono on the bottom, and we will be doing that a little bit later. And let's just say I want to do a 1-inch fold, then all you would be doing is folding it back. So there's my 1-inch there.
Oh,
I can
so
see
you
that.
Butt it.
I would butt it, and then I can iron it, because it's metal. Just keep sliding that along, so you can have a perfect hem every time.
Just honestly, with your fingers with the metal.
Yeah, definitely, but it's just really, really handy. It's a really handy tool.
It's one of those ones, once you've got it in your stash, it's a toolbox essential. When you've got it there, you've got it to use all the time. I remember working with you a while back on a show, and you added in your seam onto a pattern that we were drawing.
Yes.
And that would be a really easy way to do it. So if you wanted to add in then you could just literally measure it from there. Or however far, you've always got that marker to go to.
Mm-hmm.
It's a brilliant piece of kit. Very, very cleverly put together. I don't know who Nancy Zimon is.
She's a designer.
Is she?
She does bags as well, I believe.
Does she?
Yeah, bags are pretty cool. Basically, I know all from what I know of her, it's anything to make things a little bit simpler for you.
She's done it.
The perfect one for that. And the bag ones, they come with templates, but we should so get those on. But these, it's just anything that makes things easier for you. And once you've got one of those, you're just like... Da-da-da.
Off you go.
Off you go. Because sometimes with your tape measure, as much as we like to rely on it, over time these tend to stretch. That isn't going to go anywhere.
It's not going anywhere. Very true. And also, it's less wieldy than that.
Yeah, yeah.
Because for me, I'm always, I get it to one, I'm like, oh, whether it's centimetres or inches, I always get the wrong end.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
Always start at the 50-something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then if you're doing it in centimetres, well, the centimetre's covered anyway.
Yeah, you're all covered
up. 1.5 centimetres. So that, absolutely.
Well, it's that, so you've got your little tiddly ones, like your quarter of an inches.
It's just there.
It's not going to, because it's metal, it's not going to go anywhere. You know exactly where you stand with it. So it's definitely a really good piece of kit.
£10.95, pop it in your basket, and you've got
I'm glad you mentioned it. I'm really
SBGQ 20. There you go. So that is back in stock if you missed out on it last time. Now, back to the kimono.
Okay, then. So in our instructions, obviously it's saying that we need to be sewing in our shoulder seams in first. But I wanted to show you how you would take this to the next level. So they've mentioned French seams. So we're actually going to do our shoulder seams in a French seam.
Ooh.
Okay, so in your instructions, let me just grab my little French seam.
Well, I have
seam.
A quick question before we even start.
Go for it.
If you are changing how you do that seam, as opposed to how they suggest you do the seam, do you have to add in any extra seam allowance for it?
No.
Okay.
No. So in...
That's it.
Answer the question.
Question answered.
No. If you wanted to, then before you cut out, then add on a little bit more if you didn't feel safe enough going straight in. Does that make sense? So in the pattern, it's a 1 centimetre seam allowance. There's not a lot in there.
Okay.
Which is why I'm going to show you a mock French seam if you're not fully committed to going into the full Frenchie straight away.
Gosh.
All right. So if I just show you this side here, this is a French seam. So it's an enclosed seam. So you can see I can't see any war edges.
Ah, okay.
See there?
So this is important for something that isn't lined.
Exactly, because you don't want to be seeing those raw, untidy edges. I mean, overlocking is great, but you can still see the overlock threads.
Yes.
Where something like this just takes it to that next level. It's professional, it looks great on the... It feels great on the skin because it's not rubbing. So it's just... It's a really lovely, posh seam.
Nice.
So in order to do this French seam, you're going to need to do something a little bit different to the pattern. So normally you would put your right sides together and sew your straight seam. Wouldn't you? But with a French seam, you actually do it the other way around. So you're going to be sewing it as if you were wearing it, so it's the wrong sides together. So I'm going to do that first.
Does it feel wrong to do? Do you have to double
check
yourself?
Yeah, you do have to kind of go, am I doing that? I'm sure I'm doing that right. I'm sure that'll do it right. But it will all come apparent once we do it. So I'm going to focus on this side, just so it's easier for us. And this is my pattern piece here. So you can see that I've got my front and back laid out.
As if you were wearing it.
So in theory, if I sewed this now and did nothing with it, all of my raw edges would be facing you. We wouldn't want that, would we?
No.
So I'm just going to pin this in place. And because it's a 1 centimetre seam allowance, you're going to need to sew this at a 0.5 centimetre. So you need to do it in half.
Right.
Half first.
That's why I meant, did we have to add anything on?
No.
But you've answered that with that.
No, so you just need to do a bit of maths first, that's all.
We can do maths.
We could do a little bit of maths, especially when you've got your little handy tool, do you, a bit of maths?
Now, your very your basic instructions all come with the kit. Jenniffer is obviously taking this to the next level, so if you want to just take this and just do that little bit extra, then follow these instructions. Otherwise, follow the instructions in the kit. They are very, very obvious and beautifully displayed, very clearly set out there. £35.95 gets you all of your material and the pattern as well. £35.95 CWGC38, and that is the fabric that we're working with. So 0.5 centimetre seam allowance, all the way down, and a holding stitch or anything.
I'm not going to hold it stitch at the moment.
Oh, okay.
When I
When you're doing your dressmaking, if you're going to be sewing over that seam at some point, which in this case you will be because you'll be, one, adding a facing and two, doing a hem.
Right.
To cut time, I don't lock.
Okay.
But only if I'm going over it with a
horizontal. You don't want to come unravelled.
Yeah. Yes, exactly, exactly.
Perpendicular
stitch, yes. That's right. Okay, so we're going to need the iron out, my lady.
Oh,
thank you very
here
much.
We go. We've got a new one.
It's posh, isn't it?
Exciting times.
Super posh.
It's huge.
It is a big one, isn't it?
Big one, isn't it?
Okay, so there we have our half a centimetre seam.
Right.
Sewn. So now we need to bring that back on itself. So this is where you go, oh, right, okay. So now we're putting the right sides together.
Ah.
And then when you sew this, this is as if it would be sewn normally. But it's enclosed, so you're wrapping it around that raw edge seam. So what I would get you to do at home, where your seam is here, you could just press it, but you can see there's quite a lot of bulk in that area here.
Mm.
So what I would try and do, if you rub the seam to really push that seam forward...
I need to get this technique. Everybody else seems to be able to rub their material and to really bring it... And I just can't do it yet. What's the knack?
It's just about rolling it with your thumb and forefinger. I think if you just put your hand cream on, then maybe that's what you're struggling with. You've got lovely soft hands. You need rough hands like me.
Oh, okay.
Rough hands.
Right. My farm labourer's hands need to come out. Is that what we're
exactly,
saying?
Exactly, yeah. So I'm just going to press these out for you.
Now, what I end up doing instead is sticking a pin or something in and weakening them out that way.
That's also another way, but then you might damage your fabric a little bit. So if you can avoid
I would love to perfect this role. And I see all of our guests do it so effortlessly. And I think that will be the moment that I perfect this. I'll be like, yeah, I've arrived.
In the
dressmaking. I'm a sewist.
I think it's about applying a bit more pressure than you think you need to, I think. And it is that kind of... It's rough hands. It's rough hands.
That's it. I will not put any more hand cream on. thank you ever so much for joining us this morning. We're kimono making.
We're kimono making.
As you do. And we've got three different beautiful Amy Butler fabrics to choose from today.
Gorgeous,
all of the
gorgeous.
Kits, $35.95. It's for you to decide whether you want to go for this gorgeous sort of lavender. Is it? No, is it lavender?
It does feel like a lavender.
Yeah. And then,
like
and then that tealy colour in there.
It smells like
beautiful.
A lavender. It does, because I've used these. I've got the lavender soft rinse.
Oh, is that the one?
Yes.
Is that the thing?
That's the thing.
Now, of course, if you wanted to check your seams, then you can, because we've got our seam right back in stock today. So very, very popular, again, back in stock today. This sold out last time we brought it to air. SBGQ20. And that is just, well... It's when we've when
it's
we've
a
shown
lifesaver.
Yeah, it is when we've shown this to all of our guests. They've gone, oh, that's good. Oh, that's really good. But each guest has decided that there's a different function on here because it has so many. Well, it's a multi-tool, isn't it?
Well, yeah, it depends on what you do, isn't it? So, as a quilter, would you use it differently to a seamstress?
So, for Janice, who comes on the shows, hers was all about the buttonhole. She said that she would buy it just for that buttonhole there, that inch buttonhole. You could add a button to the kimono if you want to, couldn't you?
Oh, lovely.
Mm. What would be the most useful size for you on this?
Size?
Because we've got 3/8, 7/8, an inch, 3/4 of an inch, 1/2 inch, 1/4 inch, 1 1/8, 5/8, 1/4.
I think mine would be the 5/8, I think.
What does 5/8 equate to? Is that a centimetre?
It's almost like a 1.5.
1.5.
Smidging a bit more. Smidge. Mm.
But it's all these. You see, for me, I'm a metric girl.
Yes.
So having imperials like this is really handy because I can't necessarily visualise it.
Yes, I know what you
mean.
So
this is really handy for me.
Well, I'm an inches girl normally, but then it's weird because then I buy in metres and sew in centimetres.
Strange, isn't it?
Even though I measure up in inches.
But you see, you're of my era, so you would have been taught centimetres at school.
Yeah. But it's only through dressmaking that I'm all about the inches now.
Hey.
So if you ask me what my bust and hip and waist are in centimetres, I'd have to
check. Oh, no, I wouldn't know. No, I wouldn't know. Inches for that, yeah.
Absolutely.
Which is easier, because then you don't get so upset. Here's your seam right. So this is for, it's only second time on air, sold out first time round. If you're after this, $10.95, pop it in your basket, SBGQ20. Nice little Mother's Day gift.
It is a nice
one. One of those things you didn't know you needed until you needed it, and then once you've got it, you'll never be without it.
Like it's a microwave. One of those.
Like a microwave.
It's true.
But cheaper.
It's true. I don't know why I've decided to get rid of my microwave, but oh, I am missing it.
You got rid of your microwave?
The kitchen wasn't big enough, so we just, oh, we don't use it. Yeah, it's like that tool. Ooh. You will use it.
Oh. How do you do your porridge?
By the, see, this is the thing.
Old styly.
Just want to warm my dinner? No, that takes a lifetime.
No.
Want to measure my seams? Takes a lifetime. Any one of those little handy tools?
You do. Grab your little thingy.
Grab your little thingy.
Now, we are using the Take Flight bundle here. So you get your cloth kit bundle, and then you also get all the material. Because, here's the thing. Your feedback to us has said, well, this is lovely. You're bringing us beautiful patterns, but until I get it home and actually look on the pattern, I don't know how much fabric I need.
Yes.
So if that's okay, we'll give you all the fabric that you need, and if you're a smaller size, you get extra left over. Perfect.
Bargain.
And this is how it looks finished. Nice.
It does pop, doesn't it? But they're butterflies. They're not flowers. They're butterflies.
But that's the beauty of your Amy Bart to the fabric. The more you look at it, the more detailed it gets, the more intricate it becomes. And so it's always one of those things. You take a second glance and you go, oh, it wasn't quite what I thought. It wasn't as I thought.
Ta-da.
You see in this a nice little cream top underneath, or you could pick up the purple, the teal in there. Really.
It's just lovely. It's great fabric. And it feels lovely on the skin. Feels really lovely on the skin.
So that's because it's that cotton, isn't it? And easy to wash and wear. That's what you want.
Brilliant. So if you were just to recap, we sewed our garment the wrong way by putting the wrong sides together, which always freaks people out.
Yes.
And then we pressed our seams, really pushing that seam out as far as we can by doing our little finger rubbing and giving it a press. Then I've gone back in again and stitched again another half a centimetre.
Yes.
So on your sewing machine, it is really worth looking for that gauge on your machine. It's all there.
Yeah.
In this case of our lovely Elna, it's actually on our bobbin case.
Right.
So most people tend to look on the metal plate for where the measurements are, but on ours, it's actually, if I just pop it slightly and bring it over to you. Oh, she says.
Yep. You can do this.
So on our, there, you can see there's the 1 centimetre. And there's the half mark there. So it's that on the actual bobbin case. That's where my seam allowance is. So check out your sewing machine, because it will be on there.
That's the joy, isn't it, of modern machines. They do give you both.
It's all
generally.
There. So
generally.
I've just gone back in. So you're sewing twice. And in doing that, you're tucking all of that raw edge inside that seam. So when I open my seam, you've got a lovely, clean, clean finish on both sides. So before you go back in on your sewing machine, I would suggest trimming back, if you can, into that half a centimetre seam allowance for the first time, just to make sure that you don't have any feathers. There's nothing worse after you've done your second line of sewing and you've got all your feathers.
Look at that. And that, so just by one very simple step, you've suddenly got a professional finish seam.
Yeah.
And then you don't have to line.
No.
Lovely.
No.
Hey, do you want to come and have a look at the other, with the other different colours? Because I know that a lot of you go, oh, well, you know, yeah, but what are my options? Your options are here. So, whether you want to go really bold, I'm going to waft for you. Whoops.
We're wafting.
Now, you're getting the pattern and oodles of fabric. It's Amy Butler, so we know that this is a top quality designer in here. 2 metres of eight. I mean, you might just be buying this because actually you're getting a great, great deal with your fabrics. But here we go. So this is your Amy Butler fabric here. This is your poppies. And this is your field poppy bundle. Now, just this is what I mean by look at the Look at the background there. It's not just a plain teal background. There's a pattern within, almost like a trellis through there. So you've got those bold colours, but with the softer teals in there as well. So you've got soft pinks, vibrant pinks, but you've also got that zesty green in there as well as that warm orange. So you've got a lot in there to play with. So a beautiful eclectic mix, modern meets old, but it's absolutely stunning. And I have to say, Amy Butler, if you ever get a chance, go just Google her, and you can do a virtual tour around her house, and you can see, you can just see where she gets all her inspiration from. So you can see, you know, her beautiful gardens where she's really getting her nature, her natural ideas and stuff like that from. It's all in there. Now, so that is your poppies. There we go. And then this one, this is producer Paul's favourite. And just, do you know what? You could make these kimonos in each of these different fabrics and they would each give you such a different feel. Now, this is your organic stripe. Jennifer, the way that the pattern is cut, which way will those stripes go? Horizontally or vertically?
Well, this is the thing. As long as you're on one of the grains, whether the warp or the weft, it's entirely up to you. The pattern indicates going across the grain, which means it would be horizontal lines. But if you wanted something a little bit more flattering, then for me, there's no reason why you couldn't twist that and make them more vertical as well. It's your garment, people. Do it with it as you will. Do with it as you will.
I like this. You get all the instructions in the kit because you're getting cloth kits is back. I'm so pleased cloth kits is back. This makes me happy. It's like a step down memory. Of course, you get 2 metres is a lot of fabric, isn't it? I mean, I'm not short. Gosh, it is a real. You forget just how much that is. So an awful lot of fabric there. It is great value. And, of course, you get your pattern. And then you can continue to make these. I think what I like about these is that they are easy to wear. So here we go. This is the last one. This is the one that we're working with, your Take Flight kit here. So this is the most popular one at the moment. It always is, though, isn't it, when you can actually see it made and you can see it in that material. It's always one of those
things.
We
like to work visually, don't we, I think.
We are. I think a lot of us are. I think you're quite right. That's why we end up doing what we do. Oh, hello. What's going on here?
Okay, so if French seam was a little bit scary for you.
Okay.
I'm going to show you a mock French seam, and I'm going to bring my sample in so I can show you what that means.
Faux French.
Faux French. I do prefer the faux French. So again, it looks very same on the front. You've just got that really clean single stitch on the front.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so nothing changes there. But on the back, you can see that we still have our, there's a little tail thread there. We still have our enclosed seam. So again, it's nice and clean on the inside.
Yeah.
But the mock French is where you actually stitch the folds together. So they're still separate. It's not attached to the main fabric at all.
Mm-hmm.
But you can still see that we have an enclosed seam. So I'm going to show you how to do that now. So all I've done, I've gone ahead and sewn my pieces together. So this is the how we would do it normally, which is the right sides together.
Yeah.
And I've just created a single seam. So if I just bring that over there, so you can see right sides together.
Mm-hmm.
And then I've opened that out, and I'm just pressing my seam out at the moment. Then what you would need to do to create your mock French is you would then fold your raw edge to the stitch line. And you would go in with the
So a bit like you were making your binding, you'd fold it to the centre.
Yep.
This looks more fiddly, though, than the French.
It can be a little bit fiddly, but then I think it is scary stitching within such a small seam allowance, whereas with this, the one that you can see, you've already stitched, you've already gone ahead and done that, so you're just tidying up the insides now.
Okay.
Whereas with the French seam,
you
are having to stitch what I'm about to do first and then stitch the next one, so that you've always run the risk, potentially, of taking more off the seam allowance than you really wanted
to. Yeah.
And as we know, taking off the seam allowance means your garments come out smaller, whereas this guarantees the size.
But you do not have to dye it in order
to
wear
your
outfit.
To fit your kimono, but you are still finishing those internal seams, so they're still nice and clean and look professional.
Now, so my next question is, does that mean that you go the full centimetre on this?
Yes, so this is a full centimetre seam allowance. All I'm doing now is just curling in my edges. Actually, have we got a little... I don't think we go that small, do we?
Let's see.
Oh, no, it's quarter inch. We almost need like a quarter of a quarter.
An eighth, even.
An eighth.
So today we've got for you the Cloth Kits Kimono Amy Butler Take Flight Bundle. That's the one that we're working with at the moment. You see, even on the reverse, it looks beautiful, doesn't it?
It's just lovely.
But of course, when it's the right side up, even more
even
lovely.
Even better.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm just going to do a little section here for you and sew it together just so you can see it. And then we'll move on to our next bit, which is going to be our facings, which is super exciting. So you can see that I folded my two raw edges together.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to fold these back again. So now they're touching each other.
Yeah.
So now I'm going to go in with the sewing machine and just edge stitch those together. And then that's it.
It's like going with a top stitch.
Absolutely.
Though, isn't it?
So just make sure everything's out of the way and that you are only working with that seam, stitching those together. And that's your mock French seam. Your faux French. You're determined to change the name of this.
Yes.
Faux French seam.
Faux French seam. This is possibly, for me, more scary than doing the French.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, because
that
I think this takes more. I think this takes. It's going to take you longer.
It will take you a little bit longer, that's right.
And also, you've then got to be good at stitching quite narrowly.
Yes, you have. However, like I said, you've sewn in your one that counts, which is that outer stitch. So this is just an internal stitch. If it's wiggly and wobbly,
it
doesn't really matter, does it?
Okay, let's have a look at the pattern that we're getting with this. So, let's have a look first of all. Yeah, here we go. So this is for UK sizes 8 to 20. And we've given you enough material, whether you're a size 8 or you're a size 20, then you've got the lot in there. So you're getting a 2 full metres of fabric with this, OK? And then when you open it up, it's an absolute pleasure, isn't it? It's an easy design to follow. The fact that it's properly coloured rather than just sort of dots on one side, it's easy to follow. You can easily see which is the right way, which
really
is the wrong way. And, you know,
I like that they're even doing, like, the zigzag stitches. You can see what it looks like.
Yeah, absolutely. That's your layout as well, very clear.
For the different size fabric, depending on what you have.
Mm. Perfect.
It's
I
just,
like
it's
it
just
a lot.
It's a really, really, for me, I'm all about the beginner and I want you to be able to go through a garment or whatever it is that you're making with ease because I don't want you to hurdle, I don't want you to fall down.
You're not going to progress,
no,
are you, if you don't feel like you can
exactly,
do it?
Exactly. For me, it's all about gratification.
So
by the end of making your garment, your kimono in this case, it's going to be easy and it's going to look great. And that's what it's all about, isn't it? That's what it's all about.
It's the only thing it's all about. So this is what we're making here. That's your Amy Butler. Looking nice.
Looking gorge.
Very nice.
Totally gorge.
Yeah.
So there we have it. We've got our Frenchie all done. Our faux French.
As it should be called.
As it should be called. So we have two layers of stitching. That's the one that counts because that's the one that's going to be joining your fabric together. And this second one here is just holding those two raw edges together, those two single hems, if you like, to give you your enclosed seams. That's nice and tidy on the inside.
I kind of like that it's reinforced in a way, though, isn't it?
Yep, absolutely. It's actually quite a really sturdy seam, actually.
It is, isn't it?
Really quite a strong seam.
Nice.
So in finishing your seams in either this way or your French seam, it's going to make your garment last longer.
Well, absolutely, and because it is this gorgeous cotton, 100% cotton wash and wear. I remember when I had when I first had Freddie, just reading on websites about mums need clothes that can just wash and wear. And it's a comfy, easy thing to wear as well.
Oh yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Make it out of silk and you've got a sort of negligee type sort of pyjama-y type affair.
You absolutely, if there's no reason why you couldn't like make this in a more luxurious, maybe a sateen or like you say a silk for a night garment, for a little an overnight.
Why not then start out with this and one of the cottons?
Yep.
So you've got it to wear for your day wear. Then you've got the pattern. And when you realise how easy it is...
Just keep going.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just keep going.
And also, I think it's a very flattering top, too.
Oh, it's just great.
Because it just flows.
Just floats off the body.
Nice.
Skims off the body.
Mm. Thank you, everyone, getting involved this morning. So, if you haven't got in touch, but you would like to, this is how you do so. So, we head to the website. and you click on View Live, and that is us live. And then underneath there is a little box that says Message the Studio. That's our web chat. So if you'd like to get, and that comes straight through to the studio. Now, if you've got tomes and loads that you'd like to say, then please do email us, which is studio@sewingquarter.com. If you go below, then we've got a shopping list, if you will, of the products that we've had on the show for you. Very popular today, sold out last time within sort of 10 minutes, is your Nancy Zyman Seems Right. And it does seem right. At a great price, $10.95. It's all on there. And as we go through the shows, obviously, the products get added as we go. Lovely.
Lovely.
Hang on, what are you doing?
So, we are moving on to our last seam finish now, but I'm using this finish on my facing. This goes around the neckline and around the front of the body.
Hang on. Just the fact of facings, this could be a scary thing.
Can be a scary thing. All it is just providing a little bit of structure around the neck and the front.
Okay.
That's all it is. And it's basically a trace or a direct outline of the back of the neck and down the front of the garment, okay? So all I'm doing here, well, I've just extended my stitch length a little bit. I think the standard on this is 2.2. And I've just increased it slightly. And the reason being is I'm going to give it a little bit of a pull in a moment as I'm going to press it. And there's a reason for that. So I'm just going down the last part of it now.
Okay.
I'm still using my 1 centimetre seam allowance.
I'm intrigued as to why there's the pull on it.
So if I move my little kimono out of the way for a moment.
What did we actually have? We sewed the two shoulder bits. Was that all we had to sew on that?
We did a proper French seam on our shoulders. Mm-hmm. We've done a mock French seam on the inside, on the side seams. And now I'm going to show you how to do a straight stitch finish on what would be the neckline.
Okay.
So on our facing, it comes with two parts. You've got the front, left and right hand side, which are these parts here. Okay. And then it's been attached to what would be the last part here. So this is the same, by the way. This is the last part here, which is around the back of the neck.
Right.
Okay, so that's, you've got your main parts and then you've just got two smaller parts which are your facings. And you might be able to catch on camera here that I've done a straight stitch around the outer edge.
Okay.
Okay, not this edge because that part's going to be attached to my garment in a moment.
Right.
I'm going to do all of my pressing and stuff here before I attach it on.
Okay.
Okay, so the reason why I've done a little running stitch here with a slightly longer stitch is because I've got a curved edge here.
Right.
Okay, and I want to get that under, but I want to keep that nice curved shape. If you're doing it with an iron by hand with no stitch, what you tend to find, it almost looks hexagonal, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to take my threads. Now, I'm going to pull the bobbin one, and I know that's the bobbin one because I sewed with the fabric facing me.
Yes.
I'm just going to give that a little pull. So it just gives me a little gather. I'm going to move that gather up and along my facing. Okay. Mm-hmm. Probably could have done it further up, actually. Never mind.
So we just... I've never seen this technique before. So this is a little bit like...
Let me speed it up a little bit for you, actually. So what you would do is continue to bring those gathers around.
So it's like a ruffle?
Slightly like a ruffle. Just use my little... It's so handy, these little embroidery threads. Just pull them out, can't you? There you go. So that's that one.
So this is just going to give you that slight ruffle around the neck.
Yeah, so again, I've just shortcutted a little bit. So I've got my bobbin thread. I'm pulling it slightly.
Mm-hmm.
And if you can bring me over the iron, because then it'll make more sense. So if I put that on top of there, like that. Okay. So you can see I've got a little bit of a ruffle here. It's starting to curl up.
Mm-hmm.
By making that small gather
in
that curved edge...
Gather, that's it. That's what I want to say, not ruffle, gather.
You can see that it's wanting to curve back, but in a nice smooth way.
Yeah.
This technique is great not only for this curved neckline area, but also for your pockets. So when
you had to bring in a pocket,
Well, this is where I got the technique from. So because you've got that little line of gathered stitch and just doing that with your fabric, it's creating that nice curved edge. So when you bring in your urn, all for you.
Oh, that's clever. Is this technique in the instructions, or is this just a little added
bonus?
No,
it's just my little bonus. So what they've said on in the instructions is to just, you know, zigzag your raw edges or overlock your edges, whereas I'm finishing my edges a little bit more professionally for you. So now you can see, I'm just, the reason why I did the stitch line all the way along my fabric,
yeah.
So I know where to fold back to, so it's almost, that's my seam allowance guide. So I did, the reason why I did a really long stitch around the whole thing,
yeah.
Is because I'm folding back to that stitch line.
Could you use this?
You could use that.
Yeah, so if you've got your seams right, then you could also iron and check your allowance using that as well, which is $10.95. Seems right. Very, very popular again. If you missed out on it, it sold out so fast last time we brought this to air. So if you need this today and you mossed out on it.
Mossed out?
Yeah, missed out
on it. It's got a little mossy colour to it.
Yeah. Then $10.95 is your seams right.
Yeah, so what you could have done is just done the stitching around the curved edge.
Yeah.
And then used your seam rights down the
to
length.
To make sure you've got it absolutely spot on.
But by just doing that little gather stitch here, you can see that it's given me a nice curved edge.
That's clever. Without
on my neckline, without that kind of like hexagonal type shape. So in order to, let me move my lovely hot iron so I don't burn you, my darling. Okay. So once you've pressed your raw seams back, this is where your straight edge finish comes in. So I'm just going to bring my sample in over so it's quicker. That is a straight edge finish. All you're doing, again, is just top stitching that raw edge down. So if I flip it this way, you can see there's my raw edge. That's on the underside. So if I open out my seam for you, that's the seam. So I've just done this on it. So for instance, you didn't have to do the mock French on the side seam. You could have done this straight finish thing.
Okay.
But I'm using the straight finish for my facing.
Oh, right.
So all you're doing is once you've turned it under, like which is what we've just done on our neckline, then you just go in with a straight stitch just to hold it down. And because the raw edges are facing towards the original stitch line, it's almost become a semi-enclosed stitch. No, if you do that, that's a different seam altogether. So this one, you just need to do one fold once.
Right.
And then stitch it down.
Do you stitch that then onto the...
Yeah! Look at you learning! Well done!
See.
So this stitch I'm about to do now is keeping my raw edges down, and then we're going to attach that to the facing, and then you're pretty much done.
Oh, right.
Yeah, learning. I'm loving this, Natasha. Every time I come, you're learning something new.
I learn every day here. I've learned so much, and it's given me a lot of confidence to try new things. I have to say.
It's also, I can see it's just slowly, slowly sinking in, and it's lovely.
I'm not the quickest learner, but it's...
No, I didn't mean slowly as a bad thing.
Now, let's have a look at these different options that we've got for you today. So this is your Take Flight bundle. This is the one that we've been making this morning. And this is your Amy Butler fabric. but with a cloth kits kit, if you will. So that's $35.95. All your fabric is there. How often do you get a pattern and just never get around to making it because you never quite have enough material? We've done that for you. We've got all of the material for you. Now, if you want that vibrancy that's going to take you spring, summer, here we go. This is your Field Poppy bundle. Again, Amy Butler. All of these this morning, this cloth kit bundle, all with Amy Butler. So a beautiful designer fabric that we've matched these with, we've teamed these with. Now, maybe you want a completely different feel and you want to come away from the florals, then here we go. Go for your organic stripe there. Absolutely gorgeous. That is producer Paul's favourite. $35.95, XIGC74. Now, talking of favourites, seam rights, this is definitely one of your favourites this morning. So pleased to have it back in stock for you again because this went so fast first time round. So whilst Jenniffer has a quick sew down that seam, seams right, an easy way to get all your different measurements absolutely spot on. Whether you're, you know, poking into the corners to make sure that you've got that fold right, you've got your inch, you've got 3/8 of an inch there, 7/8 there. So if you're just marking it, then you've got those edges to go against. So you're right every time. This along here is 1.5 inches. Along here, you've got 5/8. So all of these measurements that if you're using your imperial measurements, you've got them all here. So this along here, 5/8 of an inch there. And then you've got 1/4 of an inch, 1 1/8. a half an inch there, and then a quarter. It's such a handy little tool. Very portable, just pop it in your basket. You'll barely know it's there until you come to use it, and then you'll be very grateful that it's there. That's for sure. SBGQ20, and of course, don't forget you've got that little button measure on there as well, which is super, super useful.
That's Janice's favourite, isn't it?
It is Janice's favourite.
Okay, so we have our facing, which I've done our little straight stitch finish on. So that's all done, that's all complete now. So that's all it's done. It's just bound those down, and that's what you need to do. So if in certain garments that's it, your facing would be done, you attach it to your garment, then you're done. In the instructions here, it does say to sew it down. But in theory, if you want to finish your in any other garments that you're making, and it's not saying just sew it down, that'd be a nice way to finish off your facings. So now, if I open this out just so it makes a little bit more sense for you. So this is our front of our jacket here, coming around to the neckline and going down the front. So I'm just attaching my facing again with the right sides together. So we're not doing any French seams or anything here. It's just a standard seam.
Right.
And what you need to do is match up your shoulder seams, which I'm doing there with my pins first. And then there's notches going down the pattern again. That's all instructions.
You know, you do that thing where you poke through the seam and then you match it into the other seam to make sure that you are absolutely spot on seam. Do you do that here?
Poke through the seam with a needle?
To pin.
Yeah. So I've done that there, and I'm going to just continue to pin down there. I'll just pop a few in. And then I'm going to just do just make sure that you don't use a 1.5 seam allowance. It is a 1 centimetre seam allowance in these instructions.
Okay. But it says that. It makes it all very clear, doesn't it?
Absolutely says that.
Seam allowance is 1 centimetre. Oh, it's the first thing it says on the what you need to know.
Yep.
What you need to know.
What you need
seam
to
allowance
know.
Is 1 centimetre.
That's true.
There you go.
Another thing that I'd like you to just mention as well, when you are pinning your facing on, when you get to this section and you come down here, you'll think, I've done something wrong, yes.
I'm panicking already.
You haven't done anything wrong.
Okay,
it's as per the instructions. So you can see here, this is where my facing ends and this is where my garment finishes.
What's going on, Jenniffer?
It's your hem. So don't have a panic when you see this and go, it's not fitting. Because what's going to happen is once we've sewn this on, this is going to be folded up like that. And then that would come back a little bit like that. So it does meet.
Ah.
So I just thought I'd mention it before we run out of time. Do not panic when you see
this. It's meant
to be. Don't trim. And again, the instructions will show you what you need to do. But I know so many people would have gone, I've done it wrong. And you've not. You're really, really not. Read your instructions.
So actually what happens is that hem comes up to match the width of your facing. Oh, nice.
Hence the parallel stitching. So you have a really nice continuous parallel stitching coming up around the neckline and then again around the hemline, and they're really nice boxy.
Chunky.
I think they're about 5 centimetre hem, so they're really nice, really chunky detail on there, and you do finish it off with a top stitch. But I just didn't want you to fall down on that, but I knew you were going to
I would have done that wrong. Because I would automatically assume it was me, because I'm still learning. I would absolutely assume that was me. Thank you very much for your message, Diane. She says, hello, Jenny.
Hello.
Hello to you.
I'm going to say this while you're talking. Is that all right?
She said that she wished there was a pattern with different fabrics. And here we are.
Ta-da-da-da-da! We do like to please, don't we?
Three different fabrics for you to choose from. You take flight. She says, thank you. There you
go. You're welcome.
Yeah.
You're very welcome.
Connie's been touched. Good morning. Oh, Connie, Jo Carter and her bunnies are on at 11 o'clock, but she's up next with a caravan.
Oh, it's cute, though.
It's a very cute caravan.
I think the bunny should go on holiday in the caravan.
Oh, he may well.
They will. Yeah. They definitely should.
You never know.
They fit perfectly in the caravan. Is it a storage basket, the caravan?
Well, you've got three different options.
Is one of them that it's a caravan for the bunny?
Four options. We've just developed a fourth option.
Honestly, yes. It's too cute.
All to come on today's show.
All will be revealed. Yeah, all will be revealed. Sorry to confuse you at home.
Hey, now, talk of things to come, what are you making? Because you're back again, aren't you?
I am.
What are you bringing us then?
So we thought we'd introduce you very nice and easy with our lovely, simple kimono here today. And our next show is going to be a reversible jacket.
Nice.
Okay, so this has darts, not only in the front, but in the back, and also the elbow of the jacket.
Hello.
And it's reversible.
Nice.
Two in one. So I'm going to be talking you through darts, and also I'm going to be talking you through sleeve insertions, which I know a lot of you get hung up about. So we're going to clarify and demystify a sleeve insertion on our next hour.
Well, this is excellent. Thank you ever so much for all of your messages this morning. Jill's messaged in.
Hello.
She says she's loving the show.
Good. I'm glad.
We've got lots more to come this morning. I can't believe how quickly this has come together. And actually, would have been a lot quicker if we hadn't have chatted all the way through it as well. So actually, if you need to just whiz something up very quickly, maybe you just want a glamorous something, you know, absolutely gorgeous.
Just
let me show you the different colour options that we have for you. All of these are cloth kit patterns with Amy Butler design fabric. So that was your take flight. This, beautiful. This is your poppy fields. All of these, $35.95, I do believe. So you get 2 metres of fabric with it and the pattern. So you're good to go. Just apply scissors and some pins. And off you go. And then the last one, if you're after a completely different feel, so maybe you want to step away from those florals and go chic with your stripes, then here we go. This is the one for you. This is your organic stripe, $35.95. But pick out those oranges and the greys in there. You can pick out so many different colours. It is just an absolute joy to work with. These are your Amy Butler fabrics, these are your cloth kits, and this is how easy it is to make your own kimono. You see, I think just change your jewellery. This is going to take you day to night. Come on, give us a twirl, love.
Please excuse my mic. So that's done, pretty much.
Yay.
Ta-da.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Fab. Love it.
In an hour. So do stay with us because Jo Carter is next with a caravan. Oh, yes.
I can't wait to see that.
I'll see you in an hour after that.
See you in a bit.
Bye-bye.
Follow us on Twitter for more inspiration, top tips, news, and share your own creations with us. When you spend £10 on your first purchase, you will receive this free sewing kit from The Sewing Quarter worth £14.99.
I also do some quilting and smaller scale sewing projects. I began sewing with my mum when I was really small, so it's something that's always been around at home. But then I worked for 10 years as a soft toy designer. I like to sew for different moods, but generally I like to make bears, teddy bears, go back to the old faithful stuff. With soft toy making, my top tip would always be to base things in place first, so just some stitches just to hold things in position before you do the seam properly. So within the seam allowance, just arms and legs and things, base them in place where they want to go. And when you're happy with that, then sew the seam. The favourite item that I've made probably is a panda mini quilt. It combines quilting, which I love, but also because it has pandas in and I get to put different facial expressions on them. That's always my favourite part of finishing a toy and giving it a face and giving it some personality and a smile. That project sort of combined both aspects of sewing, quilting and toy making, and they sort of came together in that project, and I'm really pleased with it. I think I'm really looking forward to the tips and finding out clever techniques about doing things and just seeing how other people work and getting to see other people's work and being inspired by it. There really is a great community around sewing, and it's very supportive, and there's a lot of sharing of techniques and tips and ideas, and it can just be really inspirational.
Did you know there are multiple ways you can contact us, even if it's just to ask a question? Our friendly team are always on standby. You can call our customer service team at 0800 112 4433, email us at help@sewingquarter.com, visit our Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter at Sewing Quarter, and even message us through our website, and our presenters will answer your questions live on air.
Join us on Wednesday the 22nd of March for our Easter Bunny Bonanza on Sewing Quarter. We've been inundated with requests for the big-eared bunny soft toy kits, and we're delighted to announce that Joe Carter is bringing Bunny back with three new fabric choices just in time for Easter. So, join Joe and the big-eared bunny on Wednesday the 22nd of March at 11 a.m, only on Sewing Quarter, Freeview Channel 78.
Welcome back to the Sewing Quarter. Right, this hour it's all about this fabulous caravan. Now, this is just one of the three ways in which you can make it. You can have it as a storage caddy, you can have it so that it opens out for your storage, or you can have it as a pincushion. So a really lovely, just look at it. It's gorgeous, isn't it? It's quirky. Look at that. So if you have someone, it's a storage caravan. That's exactly what it is, a storage caravan. Maybe you want to put your makeup in there. Maybe you want to have that in the bathroom. Maybe you want to have it in your craft room. Maybe you want to put all of your different patterns and things in there. It's entirely up to you. But this is one of Jo Carter's hours. So she's here with us this hour, and then at 11 o'clock, she's back with the bunnies that have sold out twice now on air. Yeah, so this is the third time lucky. We've got three different color options for you at 11 o'clock. So if you love the bunny, then stay with us at 11. Who doesn't love that bunny? But this hour it's all about the caravan. Again, we've bundled this for you. So in each of the two options that we've got for the bundles with you today, we've got the pattern. Now let me show you this pattern, because these are your different options that you can make. So you've got your organizer there. Then this is the one that Joe's made, so your storage. And then down here, your pin cushion version. So there we go, you've got your pattern. You're also getting, we are not assuming that you've got stuff, you're also getting your thread, you've also got your hand needles, and you've also got your interfacing. So the whole lot is in there for you. Because there's nothing worse, is there, than getting a lovely pattern and going, can't do it. So everything's in there for you, and including the fabric as well. Kind of forgot to mention the fabric, but yeah. So it's the fat quarter bundle, so six fat quarters in there, and your interfacing, and your thread, and your needles, and your pattern, and Joe Carter's everything. Here to show us how to do it all. How are you?
I'm very good, how are you?
Yes, good, thank you very much. Now, this is rather cute. Fully lined, isn't it, and everything. I mean, this is the full deal.
It is. Nice bound edge at the top, but a great storage box, especially for popping patterns in and things you have on the side of your desk.
And quirky.
Yes.
Teenagers' bedrooms.
Yes. It would also be great for various cosmetic bottles in there and things.
Well, that's what I'm thinking, you know, as an open makeup bag.
Yep.
Brilliant. We like it a lot. Beautiful gift idea.
It is.
Aren't they easy to make?
They are. There's quite a lot of work in them. It's sort of the nice detailing and things that you add at the end. Mm. It's one of those projects that, you know, you can do a bit, you know,
Dip into when you need to.
It is, because once you've got the actual structure made, then you can add whichever little details you want to the outside, bits of hand stitching and all of the yo-yos for wheels and
yo-yos
for wheels.
Yes, of course. Brilliant. So where do we even start with this?
Start with cutting out. So you want to, I would always recommend pressing your, oh, everyone would recommend pressing your pattern pieces, your templates, just so they're easier to work with.
Okay, yes.
Fat quarter bundles for this, perfect, mm-hmm. because you do need lots of little bits of different fabrics to sort of
so
bring
that's
it to life.
Why it works then, isn't it, to have it, your six different fabrics in your fat quarter bundle. And we've got, so this one is your notions. So these are the details that you've got up for the screen. This is your notions needlework because it's got, well, yeah, all your needlework notions. That's why.
They're all there.
There we go. And then you see these are the different colours that go with it. And so you've already got within it the coordination, which I like. I like things that just work and go.
It is. It's that's what I love about a bundle because you don't have to think, do you, about...
Well, the fact that you get the interfacing and everything else in there works for me.
Perfect.
Happy with that. Not having to look elsewhere for anything. Brilliant.
That, when I need something in my sewing room, I think, oh, I've got loads of that, and I get there and there's never enough.
And you're just missing a little bit. Don't worry, because we're stocking up your stash as well. So for $27.95, you get the pattern, which gives you three different options. We're giving you a six fat quarter bundle in there. We're giving you thread. We're giving you 8 metres of thread. We're also giving you... Well, it's a skein, isn't it? It's a skein. So you can then, if you want it thick, that's fine, but you can break it down into its six constituent parts. So you've got your hand sewing needles as well for those extra details. So if you want to blanket stitch or something around your windows, then you can do that. And you also get your interfacing.
You do.
It's in there. It's great. Great little bundle. QIGC05. And then, of course, you can make it as many times over as you please in its three different varieties.
Yes, I mean, I just went for the middle sort of size project in there. But the organiser and the pincushion are also really cute.
Are they, so your pincushion normal sort of pincushion size...
It's a little bit larger than the average pincushion, I think. Well, I like a bigger pincushion because mine always falls on the floor, always. So I like something that's a bit sturdier, that's harder to knock off the desk.
Okay.
When I'm
yeah. Excellent. Where do we start with all of this, Jo? Because I think there's a lot here.
There is. Start with cutting out.
Okay.
Now, if you're going to use fat quarters, this is the piece, the gusset, that goes around the sort of sides.
Okay.
And it is a little bit long for a fat quarter, but you can... just make a piece to fit, which is what I did. Here we have marks on the pattern piece, and the pattern is really well laid out, and okay. You've got all the information on there.
Because the first thing I asked you when you came in was, Jo, that looks complicated. How difficult is it to make? And you said, no, it's easy.
It is. It's really well explained. There are, you know, colour-coded things to show on the diagrams, whether it's interfacing side up or wrong side. It's.
Have we got the pattern to hand
anyway?
We have. Look at this. Okay, because as soon as someone starts saying colour code, I'm like, hang on, is this going to be like a map? But no, look, easy. No, that is easy, isn't it?
It is, so you have here your fabric key.
That's literally step by step, and so that's for that one. Then when you turn it around here, so then you've got, because you're getting three different options, and then if you've got another one there...
This one has the pincushion and part of the storage box on.
Oh, fab. So then we've got that one as well. This is great. So three different patterns, full. I think we're all agreeing, full instructions.
Yes, really clearly laid out.
Excellent.
Simple to follow.
And the whole kit. So by a whole kit, I mean six fat quarters, your interfacing, hand needles, and then thread to sew with a skein of thread, so 8 metres there, and your pattern, which gives you the three different options. So all of that that you're seeing on your screen for just $27.95. QIGC05. Okay, where do we go now?
Okay, from this pattern piece... There are points here marked. This is the turn at the bottom. So these dots correspond with where you leave your needle through to pivot everything round.
Okay.
But because they're there, I know this is this corner.
Oh, so it doesn't matter if you then make it into a seam?
So that's what I did. I folded this here, so where the dots are on either side, and then cut a piece out, leaving a seam allowance either side. And then I cut some more fabric out to the same width.
And you're not going to notice that because that is right on the bottom. Perfect.
So we have that bit with the seam allowance, and then I cut this. So I'll join some onto that side, trim the excess, and then join some onto that side.
Excellent.
So should I do that now to make the gusset piece
and
the
correct
side?
Actually, that's a majority of it done then, actually, isn't it, already?
It is. The The basic, there aren't that many pieces to make the actual case. It's all the little detailing that you can put, the details that personalise it.
As to how much you want to do. I just think it's fun. And just something a little bit different. This is one of those things that you can make for friends. Our next door neighbours, big into their caravanning. When I came home yesterday, he was out there doing whatever you do to your caravan when you're not actually caravanning in it. Cleaning it or putting electricity into it or doing whatever. And many hours spent with his caravan. But if you're a caravanner, then this is absolutely perfect. If you've got a friend who loves to caravan. My in-laws used to take their caravan so they could take grandkids here, there and everywhere.
Yes.
And it just meant that they could go to very different places and absolutely perfect. But this, anybody that you know that loves... Actually, it's because it's just a fun, quirky thing. I think teenagers are going to love this as well. Makeup bags, everything.
Yes, I think it looked great in a teenager's bedroom.
Anything to help them tidy up.
Yes.
Just a thought.
Okay, so I'm just going to... line up my marks on there and just cut away the excess so this is the right size along this side. And then I'll join a piece onto the other side.
Excellent.
There we go.
And so you make this work because we're using fat quarters with here. So the fat quarter bundle, absolutely perfect because you're getting the different varieties of colour. So with the notions that you've got on the screen, you're getting two of the sewing notions, which is the patterned material, and then you get four other colours with it. So you can mix and match. So you can make your curtains out of another and your windows out of another and everything else. So we do have another option as well, which we'll show you in just one moment, but these are the details for it. So with the other one, you get owls. It's all about the owls. So if you're all about the owl, then maybe the other option is for you. In fact, I might just grab those fat quarters so that I can show you the two different bundles that you're getting, because that's the only difference in the bundles. Everything else you're getting is the same. You're still getting your interfacing, you're still getting your hand needles, you're still getting your skein of embroidery thread there as well. So you're still getting, and of course, the pattern. But this is the difference. So let's have a look. So whilst you sew those on, I'm just going to take these out. It'll come all beautifully packaged for you, but as you know, I just like to. Here we go. These are your owls. Super cute. Super cute. How much fabric did you... use all of the fat bundle? Fat quarter bundle?
I used quite a bit of it, but there was still quite a lot left over. It takes...
So you could do a matching pincushion.
Oh, I would think you could probably squeeze a pincushion out of it as well.
I love these.
They're really cute.
Well, and then, okay, so you get two of those, and this is the same with the notions. You get two of the pattern, and then look, you get the colours that your owls are in. I saw an eagle owl yesterday. Not like, just flying about randomly. It was at a place.
Yes.
But they're stunning birds.
They are.
All about the owls. It was like an organised owly type place. It wasn't just like floating about. Look at that. Absolutely stunning materials there. So if you want to get... And this is the thing, isn't it? These would be quite tricky colours to match.
They would.
The hard work's done for you. And then you can make your caravan out of owls. How very wise.
Yeah, I really like this. I mean, all the detail, this would be perfect, wouldn't it, for the wheels?
Yeah.
And the windows.
I'd do the windows in blue. And then your curtains in there. And then you've got your whole parliament of owls going in your caravan.
It would look fab.
So this is your other option. Again, same price, £27.95. So whether you want owls or whether you want the sewing notions, let me show you the sewing notions as well, so you can... get a good idea of what you're getting for your money here. And Joe, is there anything that you need to... whilst I just flash these around everywhere, is there anything that you need to tell us about what you're doing, or should we come to you in just one moment?
I'm all right, but I'll just lay out my next sort of bit.
Prepare yourself.
I will prepare. Oh, yeah.
Okay. So all the instructions come with it. We've seen how easy those instructions are to follow. And again, you get, in your 6 fat quarter bundle, 2 of the patterns and then 4 plains, which, of course, pick out the colours beautifully. And that's why buying bundles works. There you go. So there are your notions in there. So that's why it's perfect for your sewing room, to put all your patterns and everything in. So whichever way you're going, they're absolutely great fun. Now, we're making the caravan, but you've got 3 different options. You can have a drop-down organiser. This is the caravan that we're making. Or you can make a pincushion. Really lovely, clear instructions, and we're good to go. Now, I spot a few windows going on.
I'm just cutting out some curtains. The next step is...
These are the easiest curtains I've ever seen being made.
So simple to do. A much more manageable size, I think, than a regular pair of curtains. The next step is you want to assemble or prepare the front and the back of the caravan.
Right.
So I've cut the pieces out. Okay. I've already begun the front side, but this is the reverse of the storage box.
Okay.
So with... You want fusible web iron on adhesive.
Mm-hmm.
And you trace out... Let me grab a pattern piece. So here's the pattern piece for the back.
If you want to get... We've got iron-on interfacing, but if you want a fusible one, then we've got that. We don't have a huge amount of it in stock, but it is... Oh, with a kit. Right. OK, the kit, we don't have a huge... With which one? OK, so the needles notions, the one that we've shown, this one, is low in stock at the moment. Now, Joe, we're blaming you.
Is it my fault?
Yeah. Every time you bring something to wear, it goes.
Well,
so thanks.
You do just give me really cute projects to do, though. It's not. It's that does the trick.
It's all good fun, isn't it? And okay. Oh, look on the pattern. It's giving you exactly where to place. So yes, you could place them anywhere you like. But if you are someone that has to follow exactly, and you don't want to get it wrong, then it shows you exactly even how to overlap your curtains.
It's really thorough. I mean, you have the dot for where to position the wheel later, grain line. Everything's on there. I used these to trace around onto the backing paper of the iron-on adhesive. So I traced out the shapes and then cut them out roughly and then press them on to fuse them onto the fabric.
Now, you used a bonder web.
Yes.
So if you've got bonder web, then use that. What you get in the pack is your iron-on interfacing, which gives it that sturdiness. If you want to grab some bonder web as well, then you can grab that. We've got that on the web for $2.95, and it's for a metre and 1.2 metre. So just pop it in your basket, ZJHN18. There we go. But you only use a tiny bit, don't you?
You do. You can be clever cutting out on the backing paper. Make sure they tessellate. There's just a little gap between them. So when you cut them out, so you save as much.
There you go. So that's your bonder web. But the iron-on interfacing is to give it the rigidity, not to applique with. This is for your applique. You see, when I first started, this is where I used to get really confused. I'm like, well, what do I use? Bonder web? Isn't that the same as an interfacing? I got all confused. Your bonder web to put your things like your curtains on, so that you basically put curtain to curtain, fabric to fabric, rather.
It's an iron-on glue, really.
Yeah.
But it's really great stuff, because you don't have to worry about raw edges, particularly because the adhesive holds the fabric together.
Ah, okay. And so that's what you've used for your curtains.
It is.
So just pop it in your basket, it's only $2.95. But the sewing box organiser, if you want, which is this, is your caravan. The ones that we've got for you on the screen are with the owls. So if you're after that owl, and they are super cute.
They are really cute.
Really cute. I love the colours, actually. It's the tones of it that I really like. The sort of mustard and the dusky colours. Really gorgeous. $27.95. So what you get in your kit is your skein, your black skein of embroidery thread, your hand sewing needles, you get your interfacing to give it the rigidity, you get 6 fat quarters, and, of course, you get the patterns for all 3. Nice.
A great little kit.
It is, isn't it? So, where are we at?
we're going to fuse the applique pieces onto this section. Okay. But, and I rushed ahead as I was making it at home and did stick one piece on before mm-hmm. I added the ribbon detail. So I'll just remove the backing paper from that.
Right.
And so we want to start by positioning the bottom half of the caravan front on there like that. And you have the pattern piece and you can just lay it over and check that the placement lines all line up.
Good work. It's all happening. It's all happening nicely.
I'll go and fuse this on.
There we go.
This is quite high.
It is quite high.
I'm a bit short.
Well, I'll give it a quick iron for you.
There we go. That's in position.
So this is what we're getting today. This is your So Organised box kit, which is proving incredibly popular. So whether you would like it with your sewing notions or whether you'd like it with your owls, the one on the screen at the moment, the main graphic is for your owls. And if you're after your needlework notions, that's the one on the bottom of your screen. Both $27.95. The only difference is in the material that you're getting. The rest of the kit is exactly the same. There you go.
Okay, and the next bit of detailing is to add a piece of ribbon across there.
Do you know what? If you're sitting at home going, but I don't have ribbon. Yes, you do, because your fat quarters came wrapped in a ribbon.
Oh, of course.
So you can use the, if you don't have any other ribbon, you can use the ribbon. I always keep my fat quarter ribbons. It's amazing how far they go.
Never occurred to me to do that.
No.
And normally I save everything.
Yeah, no. You'd be amazed at how many of my things end up with fat quarter ribbon on.
I have really missed a trick there.
Yeah. And presents wrapped in them, all sorts.
Just going to pin that on there and just sew along top and bottom just to secure that ribbon in place.
Okay.
And don't worry too much about if you think, oh, following that close to the edge is a bit concerning. Windows are going to go over the top in a bit.
There we go. I like this.
Chances are any mistakes will be hidden.
Is this a beginner's project then?
I think a confident beginner could tackle this.
Okay.
Definitely. Especially,
so this could be the next step up for you. If you've just started, if you've just joined with us and going, yeah, you know, I can use a sewing machine, I know how to do that, then why not? Why not take it a little step up? But you see, I think also, you're obviously a very, very competent sewer. This is what you do for a living.
That's it.
Is it nice sometimes to just relax and have an easy make?
Oh, all the time. I love a project I can just have on my lap downstairs, maybe watching a film at the same time. So the hand finishing on this is a perfect...
Well, then you can be around the family, can't you? You know,
you can.
Watching whatever they're watching and just doing whatever they're doing. We've had lots of messages. Thank you very much for getting in touch this morning. Melanie's messaged in. Good morning. She said she's loving the So Organised box kit. The motorhome owners.
Yes.
And they are. So they are. So they're going to look great. Yeah, you see, you can have these actually in your caravan.
You could, because...
I thought of that.
That's the key thing. The caravans are always big on storage. Do you take your own extra bits of storage?
Because, you know, we get a lot of messages in from people who are off caravanning. And the thing is if you go away to relax, what is the thing that you do to relax? For me, sewing and creating is what I do to relax. So, yeah, take it with you.
Absolutely.
Pop it in.
I'll trim the edges up there. Well, as I've revealed before, I take my sewing machine on holiday with me.
Yeah.
Often, not every time, but quite often. If it fits in the boot, it comes with us.
Sue's messaged in. Good morning, Sue. Sue, the bunny is at 11, so stay with us for 11. She's getting all excited about the bunny. And thank you very much, Sonia, for your message as well. She's loving your work.
Oh, thank you very much. It's always comforting. <don't
know. laughs> Phew! We're loving your work. We always love your work. So,
next, once the bottom bit's on and the ribbon...
Mm-hmm.
We can add the rest of the applique, so the windows and the curtains. And I do these one at a time. So,
okay.
Well, I do the windows together and then the curtains, one side and then the other.
This is the only thing that doesn't come in your kit that you might want to buy extra is the bonder web. So if you do want to pop some bonder web in, it's just $2.95. You can find it on the website. In fact, it's on the show. So when you watch the show live on the website, and then underneath there's the little web chat box, and then underneath is an entire shopping list. So again, use that pattern to line everything up. Oh, so your bonder web is on the bottom of the screen. There you go. 1.2 metres for $2.95. That's a lot of appliqué.
It is. It's vital stuff. You always need bonder web.
Can you iron through the pattern?
You probably could, actually. I don't. But you probably could, because you can iron your pattern pieces. And it's so thin, the heat would all transfer.
Yeah.
So now I've positioned these, and now I have to very carefully take them over.
Right, let's come back to this iron over here. Now, we are beginning to sell out of one of the kits, just if you're... which one? Okay. Is it the Sewing Notions? The Sewing Notions one is about to sell out, so apologise if you miss out on that. Please do check out your basket if you do have that in your basket so that you don't miss out on it. However... Okay, please check out your basket. However, the owls, still available. There are still owls, plenty of owls.
Owls enough to go around.
Yes.
It? Should we pop a curtain on?
Let's pop a curtain on, why not? As we're here, let's do it.
There we go.
There we go. Right, one curtain. Oh, this comes together very quickly, actually, doesn't it, once you start...
It does, you really see results very quickly.
There's more.
Yes, let's do the left side.
I love this, it's like house decorating.
It is, you can put whichever furnishings you want in.
It's fab. I do like this. This is all the fun stuff.
There we go, last curtain.
So you could do it to, once you get the pattern home, you could do it to match your house furnishings, couldn't you?
You could.
Fab. There we go.
Okay.
Yay!
I'm just going to transfer. There are lots of markings on here, and it's good to transfer them onto all pieces.
Is that the key to a successful project, is to make sure that you've transferred everything that's on the pattern onto your paper, onto your fabric, rather?
Yes. They're there for a reason. Okay. The markings, and you know, it's good to use them. I'll put one there.
And you're using a water erasable pen, aren't you? Your trusty water erasable.
I always use a water erasable pen.
We ask all of our designers to give us a list of everything that they've used, so that, you know, if you at home are making, then you'll know exactly what you need. And every time, water erasable pen for you,
always,
isn't it?
Always. I never remove that off my list of it's things on there. I'm going to need. So, once we've done that, this is the bit where you can sit down, relax with a film and do your hand stitching. Mm-hmm. Now, I've blanket stitched around the window already and then back stitched the cross, but even this is marked. You can transfer these lines on as well.
Okay.
So you're following it exactly. Now, to blanket stitch, I personally don't do it. If you're doing it correctly, you come in like this. Mm-mm. But this, because of the two layers of adhesive, it's a little bit thick. So actually, I reverse the way I do the stitch for this. It's just a tip in case you find... I don't want to confuse anybody by showing two different ways. But I go through the front just because I find it a little bit easier to go through the two layers.
Right, I see. And then
up. And come up that way for this, just because you get the same stitch... But it is just that little bit easier if this has become quite thick.
Okay. So then you go in down in the front.
So I go down through the front.
And that's because you've got that bonder web on there.
Yes.
On two. Oh, yeah, because you've got it on the...
It's on this as well.
Yeah, of course. I was trying to work out what the second layer was. Of course, you did that, didn't you?
So if you're doing it the sort of the correct method, you'd have the edge you were doing at the top and you come up, but it can be just that bit difficult.
Do you work with a thimble?
I don't know. I probably should. I just find they get in the way though.
was so, stitching something like that, and I did. I gave in. I did have to go and get a thimble, and I just thought, gosh, I can't actually remember the last time I used a thimble, but this could be the time if you need to.
My nails, my fingernails do show that I don't.
I always find with blanket stitch that actually my nails kind of end up working because I scratch them as the needle goes in. That ends up being my spacer.
Well, it's quite a handy spacer.
But you've got a polka dot there, so you can use the polka dot as your to know how as your marker.
Yes, some patterns do work out well for this.
What is it about a blanket stitch? It just adds, doesn't it, that finishing touch?
It does.
Around a project like this. Very neat blanket stitch. Look at that. Perfect.
Especially around the window, it really gives.
Yeah. Of course, this is all in your kit. You're getting your material, you're getting your interfacing, which is going to give it that rigidity to stand up. The only thing you need to add in also is the bonder web, should you wish. But there's, you know, you get an awful lot of bonder web in the extra packet. So if you're after things like your wipe-off marker, which you've just seen Joe use, £2.45, it's all on the web for you. But if you're after the kit and we've got the owl for you, then here we go, £27.95. The Sewing Notions has sold out. Actually, I may have sold out. It's certainly getting there. But always give us a quick call. There might be a couple lurking somewhere. They do like to lurk. Hello, Becky. She said, could you use fabric spray instead of the bonder web?
I don't know because I don't use... I always go with bonder web.
Right.
Because it holds the shape as well. I don't know enough about the spray to be able to say, sort of give a definitive answer one way or the other.
I've used fabric sprays and I would say there's no reason. Why not. Yeah, absolutely. You can use glue with some of these as well, can't you? Well,
the detail at the end, the sort of valance for the top of the windows, that's glued. Is valance the right word?
I'm going to say yes. It's like you'd have the valance around the base of your base, yes. Your divan bed, isn't it? Sort of, but it's all going around there. These are your little optional extras, aren't you? If you want to glue those in place, I remember working with a designer who said if you are sticking things on, use a great glue. So if you are going to stick on the valance and your wheel before you sew your wheel on, we've got some glue for you, entirely optional for you. There's your high-tack glue if you want that. So I do believe we've got the spray glue that Becky was talking about on the web.
I'll have to get some and give it a try.
Good stuff.
I tend to stick with something and then...
Yeah, no, there are two types you can get. You can get a repositionable one and then you can get a permanent one.
Right.
This is your high-tack glue. This will stick on your wheel and your the bits around the top of your window for £2.95. And I have to say, I do take that to heart because I make things for a small person. If a button or anything is going on, I will glue as well as sew.
Yes,
it's
can't be
belt
too careful.
Braces, isn't it? Just make sure that... And this is the one that I use, and that's your high-tack glue. £2.95, UGGQ37. Is that the first time we brought that to air? Producer Paul? Is that the first time we brought that one to air? I think it is, isn't it? And actually, you can also use this... you can use it on your other craft projects as well.
I have some of that. I use that to glue... When I make the stag's heads in the frame, I glue the fabric too. It's a great all-purpose glue.
So basically, if you are a Joe Carter follower, then you're going to need some of this, is what we're saying. Let's be honest about it.
We are.
Yeah. There you go. That's your high-tech glue. First time to wear, £2.95, UGGQ37. Nice. What's next?
Right. I'm going to pretend this is done because otherwise, I don't know how long we've got left, but it's not long enough for me to do.
25 minutes left.
I'm quite a slow hand stitcher. I like to take my time. So we'll skip that stage.
Okay.
And then go on to adding the interfacing.
But the instructions are all in there. We've already seen. If you've just joined us, good morning. We're making caravans, as you do, on a... What day is it? Wednesday today.
I lose track of days.
I know,
easily.
Me too. Here we go. This is your pattern. This is for the other, because you get three different options here. So that's for your fold-out storage. Nice. But this is what we're making here. We're making your caravan storage. But there's also two other sheets that give you pin cushions and goodness knows what. It's great. So nice and easy to follow.
I mean, you could make all three and have your sewing room really coordinated.
And What a great way to go. Why not?
Yeah. Right, so I'm going to add this on now with a damp pressing cloth.
Okay. So this is your iron-on interfacing.
It is.
Isn't it? Now, it says in the packet, doesn't it? Because was it you were having this conversation with about that it says on the instructions to use a damp cloth to iron it on? Like, we've never done that.
If it says to use a damp cloth, I use it. I do like to follow instructions. I like to do exactly what I'm told.
To the letter, yeah. To the T.
But you could probably get away without a damp cloth.
So pop that over there.
Yes.
Is that right?
And then just press it straight
down. You can spot the one that doesn't normally follow instructions. Yeah. Do I have to do it this way? Thank you for all your messages this morning. Connie and Lorraine, Sue, Sonia, Suzanne as well. Thank you ever so much for getting involved, for getting in touch. So lots of love messages for you this morning, Jo, as well. Who will be back at 11 o'clock with the bunny?
I will. The bunny returns.
Mark 3.
Mark, yes.
Hey. Here we go.
How's that?
How long do you have to press this for? I mean, do you think I'm done?
Well, this is quite a thick pressing cloth, so it should be okay by now.
No.
That's the problem with that cloth. Is the iron nice and hot?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Should we... Do you know what? This is all in your kit. I'm just going to go crazy and... Oh.
Should I find a little bit...
How about we just go through
this.
There we go. Don't do it through a great big thing like that. So here we go. You've got two. We're down to one option now, aren't we? Is that right? Which is $27.95, and this is what you're getting in it. So you are going to get your interfacing. You're going to get your needles, your thread. You're also going to get in there six fat quarters, and your three different options in that pattern as well. So that's looking pretty good.
That's that one.
I like that. I like that a lot. So $27.95, YZGC65. Awesome. Well, that's good. Then you can just use your other fat quarter to do that.
And you always need to press them anyway. So actually, two jobs done in one.
Done in one. Nice.
I'm all
just
seeing
if I've missed any bits anywhere. Because when you're doing it through a cloth, you can't always see. There we go.
Perfect.
Is that okay?
It is.
Do I need to do the other one?
Sorry, yes.
That's all right. I shall iron out the rest of it. You carry on whilst I iron.
Okay.
Because it's not that scintillating to watch me ironing.
Sorry, I've got more ironing.
Oh, that's all right. Boo to ironing. But this is basically giving the structure to your caravan, isn't it? So this is making sure that it's going to be nice and rigid so that you can absolutely stuff it full.
It is.
This is the caravan, this is what I'm making, and this is why it's going to hold its shape so well. Good stuff. We're a lot of people absolutely loving the caravan. With good reason.
It is really cute.
Hey. Now, you've put buttons on there, haven't you? Buttons on the show. We've got some wooden buttons on the show, if you want to. But, you know, if you've got buttons at home, that's great. If you want some lovely, lovely buttons, then we've got wooden buttons on the show.
Sorry, there's the awkward piece.
That's
it,
right.
Might be worth giving it a little press.
Should I give this a press first?
Because those are the seams from where we joined.
Do you know what? I'd quite like to have ironing is far easier if you've got someone else to sort of help. Isn't it, really?
An ironing assistant.
Yeah, an ironing assistant. Very exciting now that I bought a new ironing board, you know. Living the life. Here we go. Let's pop that on. And, of course, if this is the first time that you've used your interfacing, you've got kind of bubbles on one side. That's your glue dot bubbly bits. That wants to be face down because that's what's going to melt into your material. The hours I've spent just looking at it going, which way round? When you first use it, because often it doesn't come with instructions. You're getting the full pack. But if you've gone into a haberdasher...
Yes.
Then often they'll just cut it off a great big long... thing, weren't they?
So, they were.
Okay, so whilst I press that, what are we doing next?
Well, next, I think we shall do... I have the lining pieces, which are also... I pre-interfaced the lining pieces.
Right.
And you want to baste them together. I'm just going to trim off the excess around here.
Stocks are low on this now. You've all gone crazy for it. So if you'd like... It's the Joe Carter effect, which I'm now going to call it. Marion's been in touch. She says she's loving the show. She says that Joe's a great teacher. There you go.
Oh, thank you.
Does the marker pen disappear? It's a water erasable. We've got various on the website, so do check out which one you want, because we've got water erasable, we've got air erasable, we've got all sorts on the website. The one that Joe uses is always a water erasable. So please check out your baskets as well, because stocks are running low. I seem to say that a lot with you, Joe.
Sorry. The good thing about a water erasable pen, I often will just spray with the iron as I'm going and just remove them.
Oh, really? Oh, that's a good idea.
Just disappear.
We've had another message off, is it a leader? A lider? We're not quite sure. She said just says thanks for the inspiration, so thank you very much. She's loving the fabrics. Right. Okay.
So the next step with these pieces would be to put the lining on the back, which is also interfaced. I thought that was a bit thick. Have I managed to pin both pieces of lining?
Yay! Super rigid.
I managed to sew a cat's head to the bottom of its body yesterday.
Did you? Upside down cat?
Yes, my own pattern, and I managed to get that wrong.
You see, you needed step-by-step instructions.
Do you know, I had them as well on the desk.
That happens.
This week is not my week.
Oh, it's always your week. So this is fully lined as well.
It is. So we'd baste those together, but I'm just going to move on to the lining. The gussets, sorry.
We've been asked to show you the owls. This is your owl fabric, because this is the one that's left now. These are your owls. I think we all agree they're really rather fabulous. So you get two of the owls, and then you get four of the colours that you can see work absolutely perfectly with it. So you've got... And that's the difficult thing, isn't it? Is if you're getting a pattern fabric, is to match. And so the colour matching's been done for you in that fat quarter pack. Now, it might be that you want to use the owls for something else. I think a bag or something out of the owls would be equally lovely.
Little purse.
Yeah. Although, actually, I think the pin cushion would look lovely with the owls.
It would. Yes, I like owls. In fact, my name on social media is Joe Two Owls.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
It is. I'm an owl fan.
Loves an owl. So stocks are not that great anymore on these. We are selling them really rather rapidly. So if you are after your owls, then please do check out your basket. Hey, I tell you what else we've had on the show that I didn't mention has been your creative grids. We've had some amazing creative grids on the show.
I love those. Now, I've not seen them before.
Have you not?
No.
Okay, so Creative Grids are a family-run company. And the really lovely thing about it is, you see this sort of opaque bit around here? That's actually a grip. It's a non-slip grip, and you can see it in the circles here as well. But it's not like some of the rubbery ones which you think is going to come off. It's sort of embedded, you can just see, almost embedded into the plastic itself. Now, on one side, you've got a half inch, and on the other, you've got a quarter inch, so that when you're actually looking through, it's really easy to see your half and your quarter inch measurements. The white measurements here are your plain inches, but then on the other side, if you spin it around, you've got inch and a half measurements, so which is very, very handy to have. So a real great little one to have. This is a 6.5 inch, that's 16.5 centimetres. I have to mention that there are no centimetre marks on here, but legally I have to give you the centimetres, because that's the crazy world we live in. But this is a 6.5 inch square. So if you're doing a finished six inch quilt block, this is great, $16.95. But to be honest, actually really handy to have just as a little ruler. That means it's not going to slip, because you've got the grip.
Well, that's always the worrying bit, because when you have a rotary cutter and it moves, you've lost then your edge.
Not only is it dangerous, but you've also then, your cut's not right, so then you've got to start again and you've wasted material. Don't like to do that. So, you know, for the cost of $14.95, make sure that you don't waste any more material. RTCQ48, right.
Yes, I only saw those for the first time last week, I think, and they are brilliant.
Now, what are we sewing together here?
I have the the lining and the top, the exterior gusset piece, and I've just put them wrong size together, and I'm just basting them together along the sides, and I will around the opening as well.
Please check out your basket if you want the caravan, because stocks are very, very low. We've already sold out of one. It's only the hours available now, and we are getting very low on the hours. $27.95. This is your So Organised box kit, YZGC65. But if you're after some buttons, we've got some very cute little wooden buttons here. And I believe these are $1.45 or something like that for... $1.95 for your buttons there. $1.95 VIGQ41. They're good buttons. They're sort of, you know how some buttons are just really pleasing?
Yes.
They've got a nice curve to them, and everything is just nicely rounded. I like.
They're lovely. Perfect for the inside. Is it the hubcap?
Yeah. And your door
and
as well.
And the door handle, yeah.
But it's, you know, there's no, you know, it could have just been like a sharp point there, but it's not. It's, so it's all very pleasing. A pleasing button. Everyone loves a pleasing button. So we just go around the outside. Is this within the seam allowance?
It is, so you don't have to remove the stitches later. Now, I have decided to sew down the other side, and my pins are on the opposite side, so I've decided to make life difficult.
For myself. Why not? I mean, it's only live TV. It doesn't matter.
It is.
I love how our designers do that. So I've never done this before, and I just thought I would give this a go.
For the first time
yeah,
ever.
Thought I'd give it... just go, wow. Complete respect to you for that.
This was just not thinking it through, I think. If I'm going to be really honest, I think I...
Brutally honest.
So I'll just do this really quickly, just so we get onto the binding. Because the binding looks... It can... I think, we're going around curves, and you're sewing it when the gusset is attached in a loop as well. But if you clip it in the right places, it's not such a problem.
Okay. But, of course, full instructions. So if you've watched Joe this morning and gone, yes, need to make this, it comes with full instructions in your kit. So for $27.95, you get the instructions for the three different projects. You get six fat quarters. You get your interfacing. You get your needles. And you get your thread in there as well for all your hand stitching.
I've just realised I've done it wrong.
Okay.
Oh, do you know, right, I'll carry on, but I will say how it should have been done.
Okay.
Correctly. See, it's not my week, is it? These should have been joined. So the exterior and the lining should have been joined and sewn along there so that you don't have the joined seam in the bottom. And then you join them as loops. Now, I've done this. In fact, I'll just whizzle on because I've not... and separate them because that... Because you join the lining pieces for the front and back.
Oh, I see.
In a different way.
What's your pick? We've had a customer, good morning, who's asked about P&P. Our P&P is a little bit different from other shopping channels that you'll see. So for us, P&P was a very important thing when we were planning the channel. We're like, right, we want P&P to be really fair for you. So I'll tell you how it's not done, and then I'll explain how it is done. It is not done per item. It is not done by the number of times you check out your baskets throughout the day. So what that means is you can buy throughout the day and check out your basket as many times as you like. Absolutely fine. At midnight, we will just apply $2.95 as your P&P, and that's it for the day. So our P&P is done per day. $2.95 flat rate. You could buy the entire store and we'd only charge you $2.95. Took me a little while to get my head around. I was like, what? But hang on, surely it happens every time I check out my basket. No. It's just at midnight. We tot up everything that you've bought for the day, apply $2.95 P&P across for the day, and that's that done. Easy.
It's really good because if you've ordered something in the first show and then you see something in a later one...
Well, and also because it's annoying, isn't it, if you haven't finished shopping and but you know that something's going to sell out and you don't want to miss out on it, but you don't want to be charged an extra P&P. That's why we did it. We want you to be able to check out as many times as you want without that worry of basically... Because sometimes you can end up spending as much on an item again, can't you? Just
really
on the
can.
P&P. So for just $2.95, that's that done.
Right, so I've decided that today I wanted to showcase the seam ripper.
Okay, yeah, which is a great tool.
So this was absolutely a deliberate mistake.
Yes. Do you know what? Sometimes when things go wrong on air, you know, it's one of those things that actually it's quite refreshing to see that even for the professionals,
You never get to a stage, no matter how much sewing you've done, you never get to a stage and think, I've got this sussed, I can throw this away.
Yeah, no, never. It's never the case, is it? Always those seam rippers. We've got a low stock warning for you, so if you are after your owls, if you are after the caravans, then please do check out your baskets. £27.95. If you have just joined us and going, what is she talking about, owls and caravans? This is what I'm talking about. This is one of three options that you get with your pattern, with your interfacing, with your thread, and with your needles. We are very low on stock. You're also getting six of your fat quarters. Now, this was the one that sold out. That's the colours way that sold out, but we do still have for you your owls. But again, stocks are very low. But six fat quarters here in this bundle. You get two of the owls, and then you get the other four coordinating fat quarter colours to go with it. So $27.95, YZGC65. Nice.
Right, I've nearly done now, and I will try not to make a habit.
No, that's okay, because I've been asked to show this again, because I think this is only like the second time this has been on air. So this is your creative grids, and having worked with quite a few of our quilting guests, they swear by it. They're like, this is the Rolls Royce of grids. So, again, all of these sort of opaque parts that you'll see, that's your non-grip. No, non-slip grip. I keep saying that the wrong way. Non-slip grip on there. And do you know what's really clever? If you've got one of those QR readers, then you can scan that in on your phone, wow, and it takes you straight through to YouTube to videos to show you how to use it.
Really
of
clever.
Creative grids, not like random videos, just how to use it and projects in which you would use this. And it gives you lots of different ideas. If you don't have this and you can't scan that in, then you can just search. Oh, and there you go. You see, this is it. When you have techie boys upstairs, they have just checked it and it does work.
Perfect. Well, in that time?
Yes. They've managed to get their hands on it. You see, this is it. They're checking. They're checking for everyone that it works. There you go. RTCQ48. So you get a video tutorial as well.
Perfect.
That's awesome, isn't it? $14.95. Worth its weight in gold. And it even has a little hook thing there so you can hang it up and store them. Nice. Very nice. We're sewing again. What are we doing?
We'll just cut that bit out.
Yeah.
Fine. You want to join them at the bottom.
Right.
Like this, before we baste them together. I only made that yesterday, but I managed to forget. So that's why you need the instructions next to
you. Oh, that's because I've got your instructions here.
What are they?
Do you follow your instructions? Look, hit 9. Stitch bottom seam and gusset lining.
See, is that there?
Yeah. That's the one, isn't it?
See, everybody makes mistakes.
Patricia's been in touch. Hello, Patricia. Oh, Patricia, the fabrics are only available in the kits, so that's why we've sold out of them, I'm afraid. So, if you're after them, please check out your baskets. Always worth giving us a quick call, just in case one of them's bounced back or anything. But we've got a few more of the owls, but the sewing notions have sold out.
All gone.
Mm. So there you go, that's your kit.
I have done this step now.
Yay, step number 9.
So I've joined them together.
Yes.
And now we want to pin them together, wrong sides together.
Step number 10.
Yes.
Yes.
So all
which is kind of where
course.
We were.
It is. Here we go.
So
it's always a good idea to start at the bottom with the seams to join those up. My fingers don't want to work now. There we go.
So, seam to seam.
I just want to pin around the edge.
You know when you... the top of this, is this... The top part here, is this just done with a binding?
It is. It's a binding strip. And, again, this is...
It shows you
really
how to make
explained.
It.
And even little things that they've asked you to do, they're in little speech bubbles here, it will say why you're doing that. And it's always... Because sometimes you're doing a pattern, you think, why am I doing this?
For example, stay stitching will reinforce the seam, allowing you to clip to stitching. There you go. Let's you know. I've got some... oh, nice. If you don't want to make your own binding, I've got ribbon. This is your ribbon. I've got lots of ribbon. Double-faced polyester satin ribbon.
They'd be great for the, well, the ribbon trim that goes across. Yeah. Or the, are they valances? Are we?
These are, I've got 10 mil and I've got 15 mil. So which one have we got? That's your 15 mil. So 20 metres? Gosh. Oh, it says don't iron it. That's all right. I don't like ironing anyway. UMGQ03, £8.45 for 20 metres. Great if you're doing bunting.
Absolutely, that'd be perfect.
Wouldn't it? And we've also got a 10mm version as well. Oh, hang on, have you seen this ribbon though? This is rather lovely as well. Yeah, can I show this one? Look at this one. This is your natural charms. This is how ridiculous it is. I've been stood in front of these and just not noticed. £4.45, but look. Lovely. It's like it's got a stitch through it.
I love those.
It's lovely, isn't it? Really nice. £4.45. NVGQ48. Right.
So the next step is we were based along the sides and around here just to secure mm-hmm. these pieces together. And then the binding, it's fully explained, but you press over 1.3 centimetres, so half an inch. Mm-hmm. And then this is the edge. The folded edge is the one that will fold over and then you'll hand sew on the reverse.
Now, you could use a bias binder maker, couldn't you?
You
to
could.
Make that. Which one would that be? The 25mm one? Is that...
This, I think, is 2 inches. Is it 2 inches? Which is 5 centimetres. Yes.
Yeah. There you go. So there you go. We've got bias binder makers on the website. Oh, in the next hour, even. Hey, gosh, so actually, just take your time with it and it's going to come together a treat, isn't it?
It will. And when you add your binding, clip this around the corner. Just you pin it on first, but if you clip, it just means you can ease it around the corner a bit better. And it's on the bias, so you do have that stretch, but clip there. And also in the instructions, but when you're adding the sides later, clip the gusset around these corners just so it flexes.
Now, this is what I noticed, actually, with a lot of the things. Anytime it's on a curve, give it a little snip around just... And ease is the word. That's what our guests always say. Just so that you've got that ease to go around. Yeah, we're nearly out of time.
I know.
It's craziness. We've got a minute left.
It flies by.
Thank you very much for joining us this morning. Jo is, of course, here. Well, she's been here this hour. And you'll be back again with the big-eared bunny.
I will.
I feel like we're making, you know, making personal remarks about him, but he does indeed have big ears. We've got 3 different options for you on the big ear bunny. So get in quick if you missed last time. We've brought it back quicker possibly than we should because of Easter. So we still don't have amazing amounts of stock because we make all the kits ourselves. So sometimes it takes us a little bit of time to pop them all together. But we do have some for you. So do stay with us for 11 o'clock and you need to get in quick there. We are going to make a double-sided jacket / kimono with Jenniffer Taylor next hour. So do stay with us for that. And then, of course, bunnies at 11. So lots to stay tuned for. Grab a quick cup of tea and we'll see you in a couple of minutes. Thank you ever so much.
Thank you.
See you in a moment. Bye-bye.
Join us on Facebook. Simply search for The Sewing Quarter and like our page for the latest news and more.
My name is Jenniffer Taylor and I am a seamstress, a self-taught seamstress. And the first thing I ever made was my wedding dress was about 5 years ago. So I started sewing when I decided to make my own wedding dress because I purely couldn't find out what I wanted. I couldn't find it anywhere, so I just thought, right, I'm gonna make it myself. And then from that point on, I just couldn't stop sewing. I got addicted. I think we can all say that here. We're addicted to sewing. When I decided to take on the wedding dress as my first project, everyone did think I was a little bit loopy. But they know that I'm quite tenacious, so they knew what I was doing it for and they kind of let me go run wild with the sewing machine. But yeah, everyone thought I was crazy, but I knew what I had in my mind. I knew exactly what I wanted, and the only way I could get there was to do it myself. My favourite thing to make would be dressmaking. I love to dressmake. But actually, dungarees. Dungarees are my favourite. Ever! Dungarees. Why? Because there's pockets. I love pockets. I need pockets for everything. So yeah, dungarees are my ultimate favourite thing to make, without a doubt. My top tip for sewers would be don't be afraid to make mistakes. I know you've probably heard that before, but it's so true. Being self-taught, I learn a lot by making lots of mistakes. So get a decent unpicker would be my top tip. I am really excited about working with Immediate Media because they have such a fantastic position with magazines. They're all about great projects, whether it's quilting, sewing, or even cake or cars. They know exactly what they're talking about, and they've got a passion for hobbies. And for me, my passion is sewing, so it's great to be working with somebody who's really enthusiastic for that. So my favourite item has to be my wedding dress. It has to be my wedding dress. It was the thing that started my sewing journey, and from that point on, I haven't stopped. So yeah, it was hard work. I cried a few times. I think there's some blood on there somewhere as well. Blood, sweat and tears went into it, and it is my favourite thing, and I'm really, really proud of it. I think, well, going to craft shows, I'm hearing from everybody that comes to visit me that they want more sewing, I demand more sewing, and to have a channel completely dedicated to sewing and quilting is just what everyone's been crying out for so long. So I'm glad, I'm all about getting the nation sewing, and to have a channel dedicated to that, I'm just excited. I am really looking forward to having a poke around in the warehouse. Don't tell anybody, but the goodies that they've got in there is so exciting. I can't wait to show you. So just being surrounded by amazing fabrics, beautiful patterns, is just a treasure trove.
Welcome back to the Sewing Quarter. Hello. We're here this hour with this beautiful jacket here. So we're looking at, do you know what? This is the magic of it. I just want to show. Look. Reversible. Oh, yeah. So two in one is how I like to look at it. Yeah. Really beautiful. So this is what we're making. No collars or anything like that, but it is reversible, so a little bit of a twist. Again, this is from Cloth Kits, so a company that, gosh, I was dressed in as a child, and I'm so pleased that to hear this name again. God, it really takes me back. A lot of happy memories of Cloth Kit clothes, so to know that they are back is absolutely fab. So this is your Cloth Kits boxy reversible jacket. So this is truly one that you can have day wear, whoosh, whack it inside out, evening wear, however you want to have it. Maybe you want to have your plain fabric. We've done bundles for you again because that's what you've been asking for. So each of these colour combinations will come with full instructions here. And we've seen earlier, we're looking at the Cloth Kits kits, how beautiful the instructions are, how clear they are, how easy to use. So we're going to give you a plain with each and a patterned with each, and also some thread to work with as well. So that is, if you just want the pattern just by itself, it's $12.95. But then if you want to grab the fabrics, then we've got those for you. So we've bundled the fabrics for you. So if you would like to get, now, this is all, the patterns are Joel Dewberry. You're getting 2 meters of each. So you get 2 meters of your plain and 2 meters. There we go. Now, this is the one that's on the inside of the jacket. So just step with me over here a second. I'm going to wander. That's the fabric that's on the inside. Now, Jenniffer Taylor's with us today. She did us a reversible one so that you could see what these patterns look like. But yours would be maybe grey on the inside. But here we go. Oh, there. You've got a picture of it. Perfect. That's what your finished product will look like. $36.95 gets you the fabric bundle. So that is 2 meters of your Joel Dewberry and 2 meters of your plain as well. So 4 meters of fabric in that. That's $36.95, and then you buy your pattern on top of that. There you go. Now, next one. Love these two together. I can hear Jenniffer Taylor. This is your colour. This is very much her colour here. So here we go. We've got this 2 metres of this gorgeous Joel Dewberry. This is your bizarre fabric. And then here, you get there, that's your plane that's really making that green pop. It's kind of a golden green though.
Gorgeous.
It's really lovely. Perfect. $36.95 XKGC20 is that one. So, you know, whatever you're colouring, there's a colour for you today, because this is your third option here. You see, this is my colour. These are my colours. Very much so. Aren't they beautiful? Almost like a lotus flower on here. I love this. Look at that. 2 metres of each of these fabrics. So 4 metres in total. That's your reversible jacket. That's gorgeous, isn't it? I mean, really, just so stylish. So whether you want to have this as your lining and have little cheeky something, or whether you just want to have that vibrant lining with that gorgeous teal there, it's up to you. $36.95 ASGC52, but it's stylish. It's super stylish. Now, the pattern itself is $12.95. Pop that in your basket, and this is what we're making here. Really lovely. Who's making us helmet, I hear you ask? Well, it's only our very own Jenniffer Taylor.
Hello!
Hello.
Did you have a nice cup of tea?
I did have a nice
relax,
cup of tea.
Relax, put your feet up.
I did.
Everything good?
I really enjoyed the little caravan.
It's great fun, isn't it?
I love it. I know it's a storage basket, but I think it's a great thing for the kids. Like, as a toy, a soft toy.
Oh,
you've got your bunny. It's going on a little caravan, a little holiday.
I'm all about the storage with kids, if you can make their rooms tidy.
Forget about the storage. It's just a play thing. I love it. I want to play with it. Honestly, it was so cute.
I think you have it in the bathroom and put toilet rolls in there.
Bah!
Yeah. Bah! Right, but this hour we are making this boxy,
the boxy jacket.
I love this one.
It's a really, really nice pattern.
But how easy? Because that's the thing, isn't it? Generally, the things that I absolutely love, I just can't do yet.
No, it might look complicated, but it's basically just two jackets sewn together.
Really?
Yeah. It's the same pattern twice. Stick it together and then finish it off with a binding. Honestly,
is that
really,
why
really
the binding's
lovely.
There?
Yeah. So when we put it all together, all of the raw edges are on the outside. So you cover them. There's no bagging out. There's no reversing. None of that. You're just sticking them together like you would wear it. And then off you go with your binding and it's done. There's a little bit of shaping in the bust area. There's a little dart in the shoulder. And there's a dart in the elbow, which we're going to go through today.
Is that normal?
It gives shape to the jacket. So, yes, if you go digging in your wardrobes and go and look for your jackets, you'll probably find one in there somewhere. They don't always have them, but it is a really nice feature, and a little shaping in that elbow area.
So whether you are a size 8, UK size 8, or whether you are a UK size 20, if you're buying the fabric bundle, then there is enough material in there to go from a size 8 up to a size 20. It's bundled for all the sizes. Then grab your pattern and you're good to go.
Got it all
covered. 4 metres of fabric. And to have a designer fabric in there. Top American designer, Joel Dewberry, one of our favourite designers here. Absolutely stunning.
Just beautiful fabric to work with. It's a dream to just iron. And I don't like ironing. Pressing I'm okay with. I can press when I have to, but not I actually really enjoy. Just, that's satisfying. La, la, la.
But that's the marker, isn't it, of a really good quality cotton.
Yeah, I think because you're going to be wearing these, the last thing you want is a garment that you're just like, why aren't the creases getting out of it, you know? Whereas this is just, it's so easy to wear. Really light, just lovely. And like you say, that designer touch.
Did you make that jacket in a size to fit yourself?
I didn't, no, I should
have. Why? Why?
I know. Oh, and there's plenty of fabric. I don't know why I did it. It's ridiculous.
Oh.
I just kind of went for it and just got on with it. I think my theory was if I make it in a smaller size, it's less desire. You've got to get the prep in, haven't you?
Okay. $12.95 for the...
it's definitely worth going. I know we went through the instructions on our first show, but again, I really, really like the instructions. They're really user-friendly. They're not scary at all. Everything you need on there, from putting your pattern onto your fabric, little hints and tips, how to put your binding on, tips on your binding. It's just a lovely, lovely pattern.
Fair.
So if you are on the fence on dressmaking, then this is the pattern for you, I think. Definitely.
It's so clear. It's coloured as well, then it just makes it so obvious. In none of the shading business, it's all done.
It's very
in
clear
colours.
What you need to be doing.
Really clear. Amory's messaged in, good morning.
Good morning.
She says, loving the shows today. And Marilyn says, hello, lovely ladies.
Hello.
She's a make a brilliant team.
Oh, that's really kind of
us. We've been working together a year or so, haven't we? Now,
this is your pattern. It's worth getting this one out because whereas on the kimono, it was more of a relaxed style. You had your small, medium and large is covering the ranges that you said, which was 8 to 20, wasn't it? And this one, you do need to cut out the appropriate pattern.
Okay.
But again, I just want to say, I love the fact that it comes out in paper.
You love proper paper, don't you?
Yeah, because I just think they're more robust. Yeah. They last longer. You can make them for your friends. You know, it's going to stand the test of time. So, you know, £12, it's great value anyway, but then the fact that it's on paper, it's going to last that longer. You know, it's just great.
So here we go. $12.95 gets you your pattern. Now, here, you've got your sizings.
Yeah.
So, if you measure your bust, and it is all in centimetres,
I know,
then you pop it in which size it's going to be.
Which size you need, that's right. So don't just go, I'm a size 14 cut.
No, so just
make sure
you don't
check.
Even have to write the centimetres in. You could just write chest.
Yes.
Okay. Waist and hips. It's all there for you.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
To go. Love this.
So the difference between this pattern and the last one, and it does state again very clearly on our top section here, where it does state pattern pieces include a seam allowance of 1.5. So it's not the same as the last one. So always read your instructions, guys, because then you're more likely to make mistakes if you don't. They are there for a reason.
Never assume
that it's going to be the standard 1.5. So yes, this one is 1.5, but our kimono from my first hour was only a 1. So it's always worth checking.
Do you know what though? Once you get used to the cloth kit format, then you'll see the very first thing they tell you is your seam allowance.
Yes.
It's like it's kind of shouting it at you. There you go. Your seam allowance is 1.5 centimetres.
Except around the bound edges. Read that bit.
Yeah.
It's true, just read your instructions. They're there to help you, not hinder you.
Have they added in the seam allowance? You don't have to
add it. No. You haven't got to add it all on and do all that. Just go for it. So again, because this is a beautiful, beautiful pattern that's going to last forever, I've traced around my pattern and you could see really clearly because the lines are nice and bold. So I just got some normal paper. You could use newspaper at home if you wanted to. Just give it an iron first.
And then transfer everything onto there.
That's right.
What we're making. If you've just joined us, maybe you've got your chores done for the morning. This is what we're making.
Let's make another boxy
jacket.
That's
one of them. But hey, here's the thing. This is a reversible boxy jacket. So, can we show the other side?
By the power of magic.
By the power of by the power of... It's coming up.
We can see it. You can see it now.
That's the other side of it.
I love how that pops.
Now, you see, that's your pyramids. Now, we've put that with the grey that you've got. Pyramids
with the grey
down the bottom there, $36.95. We've done that with the grey, so that will be your contrasting lining on the inside there, and then the normal one, the lotusy flower. What's the proper name for the lotus flower one?
Bloom. I think it looks like lotus too.
Yeah, it does.
Very
isn't it?
Art deco though, don't you think? Very art deco. I love it.
Oh, beautiful. The bloom is again $36.95. That is coming with a dark teal plane.
Gorgeous.
But of course, there's nothing to stop you. If you wanted to do patterns both sides like you did.
Yeah.
And then just use your plane for your binding.
Yeah, of course.
You can completely do that.
Well, it's like you said earlier about, you know, when you've got the jacket with like, I don't know, you're going straight from work to meeting friends or something like that. So you want something a little bit more conservative for the day, but then you want to jazz it up on the night. This is what we're giving you.
What I love.
It's like a Superman moment.
Yeah. I love a jacket. I love a nice...
You do like a jacket.
I do like a jacket. But what I love more than just a jacket is a jacket with a funky lining.
Yeah.
And that's what this is giving me. On both sides.
Yep.
Either or.
Gorgeous.
Either
absolutely or. Gorgeous. And of course, the pattern that's giving us that flexibility is 1295 SGCY80. And then you pick your fabric bundle. I must stress, this is the fabric that you're buying. If you want the pattern, that is 1295.
Separate.
Yes.
Separate.
But you're getting 4 metres of fabric. You're getting basically two jackets in there.
You are.
Two jackets for $36.95.
That's correct.
Hello.
Hello.
That makes me happy.
So, yeah, because it's reversible.
Yeah.
I'm with you now. I was thinking, no, yes, you do. Yes, right. Okay, so as you can see, I've got my front and my back. I've got my sleeve over there. So you've got your two pieces.
You've copied everything across.
Copied everything across. So you can see here that I've got my grain lines. Again, these are really important to work with. Make sure you get those out. And you notice there's little green triangles in the corners as well. These are our notches. So again, make sure you're transferring those.
So you line your grain line so that it's parallel to your selvage.
That's correct. That's absolutely correct. And whereas this one, it's not. It's on the fold. And I know that because it told me to do it on the fold. So that's all done. And the last thing that's really important is these ones here, these crosshairs.
Ah, okay. It's got a dart.
There's a dart coming here. So here we have our front. Mm-hmm. So we've got a dart coming in from what would be the side seam into the bust area.
Is that what this is sticking out for?
Yes.
Oh.
So you've got a little notch here,
yeah,
and then you've got this little triangular kick, and then you've got another point there, which they haven't notched, which you wouldn't need to because you can clearly see where the fabric is. That's going to be the wide part of the dart, and then we're going to be moving into the smaller part there. So I'm going to walk you through all of that. But then there's another one here, which people might overlook. There's also another dart here.
That's into a the tiny dart.
Into the shoulder seam.
Discreet dart.
Shoulder seam.
Yeah.
So, again, it's just adding some shape around that area. So this is another one we need to make sure we get in.
If we have a look at the... Can we take a look at the shot of the jacket or just get a shot of the jacket? Because you'll see how beautifully... Actually, I'm going to come across and take a quick look at it because this is the thing. Because you've got that dart and the dart goes down the back...
Twist it. There it is.
There's your dart there, but it just means... Can you see it there? It shapes
just
it.
Just add shape into that
so
neck. Into the neck.
Look how beautifully that is just sitting through there. So this is bespoke. It's tailor-made. It's going to sit absolutely beautifully. And, of course, the other dart is coming across here. And it's just giving that beautiful shape. But, you see, look at this. It's sitting. Pair of jeans.
Yep.
Turn-ups, crop jeans in the summer.
I like the fact that you can
nice.
Roll back the sleeves and have a little peekaboo as well.
Doing that. Would be so thrilled if I'd made this. Look at that!
That looks so good, I love it!
Oh, I love that.
It's cool, isn't it?
It is very cool. It's a very beautiful
jacket. Told you
it was
all about the boxy jackets today. I love it.
So, we did it in two different... versions of the fabric so that you could see what they would look like. But you're going to have a plane, so you'd have a plane there or on the outside because it's reversible, and then obviously a pattern on one. But there's nothing to stop you from buying extra material and doing whatever you
mix
like.
And match
whatever
it.
You like. But $12.95 is for your pattern there. So Joel Dewberry.
Dewberry.
I mean, Joel Dewberry, he was a graphic designer. He is a graphic designer as well.
Oh, I did not realise that.
Yeah. As well as a fabric designer. And I think that often comes through, especially in a lot of his geometric designs.
Yeah. Loving that mustard.
Clever man.
Loving that mustard. Okay.
Child of seven.
He's
the second child out of a family of seven.
Wow. Mind you, my dad's from a big family.
Really?
I think he's probably got about seven or eight, I think.
Oh, well, I lost count.
He was the youngest, though. He was the youngest of that.
Yeah, my grandmother was the youngest of 10.
Oh, wow.
Can you imagine?
Wow.
Yeah. Okay.
Right, so I've transferred all my notches. The one thing that I haven't done is my dart. So I'm going to do that with what's called a tailor's tack. So I'm going to walk you through that now because it is really important to do that. Because the last thing you want to be doing is making any marks in your fabric where you can see it.
No, don't
okay,
do that.
Marks in the side is fine, but marks in the fabric, this is where you would use a tailor's tack. So I'm going to go with a really bright red so I can see what I'm doing, needle and thread. And I'm literally going to be piercing where that crosshair is, making sure I'm going through both layers of fabric. There you can see my pin there, so I have done that. I'm going to place it through one, so I'm going to leave a nice tail on there, so that should be more than enough. And I'm going to go back through again to create a loop.
So just make sure I check that. Okay. So you want to create a tail, a loop, and then another tail. And then I'm going to use my scissors and just give that a little snip. So that's one tailor's tack done.
So I'm going to do the other one now, just again, just in case you've missed that. So I'm going to go through the fabric.
And the fabric that we're using is the pyramids, which is what is up on your screen, just over there. AGGC 48. And that's actually in a bundle with the grey. So the grey colour that you can see that jacket's bound with, that's the colour that this is coming with.
I love that stark contrast.
Lovely, isn't it? So there's our tailor's tack done. And the reason for the loop is so when you separate your layers, which you're going to do in a minute, you don't lose your tacks. Oh. I've just noticed that I haven't clipped, made a transfer my notches in the side there. So I'm just going to do that very super quick. So I'm just making little notches with my scissors. These are super sharp, which is great.
These are your rose gold coloured scissors. These have been so popular. $16.95. for those, and they are on the website.
They are.
So these notches, why is it important to transfer these?
These are your keys for your garment. So it's basically, think of a jigsaw puzzle, certain pieces go together.
Yeah.
These little hieroglyphics, as I like to call them, are telling you where these pieces need to go. So the single one here and the double here is referring to a sleeve and where you would position that. So when we do our sleeve insertion, I'm going to go through that really super slow. So we're going to be mastering darts today in sleeve insertions. These are going to tell me which way my sleeve is going to go, especially if you've put your darts in. You don't want your dart facing the wrong way because you've put your arm on the wrong side. So all these notches are telling you the way they need to go together.
I can't imagine why you're looking at me when you say things like that.
What? I don't know what you mean, Natasha.
I don't know.
Look, we've all done it.
I seem to make for, like, sort of Frankenstein.
No, it's true. The thing is, we've all done it. And, like, again, very quickly, I could have just gone ahead, taken my pins out, and not realised that I haven't done my side notches, and then come
double
to that.
Check.
Yeah, exactly. So before you take any of your pins off, triple check that you've not missed any of your notches in your pattern before you remove it. All right.
Now, talking of removing, because obviously we've got a tailor tack in there, do you just rip your paper?
So what my little tip, when you've drawn out your pattern, so before you even get to your fabric, and when you've got anything like this, like a dart, what I do is I fold my fabric to that point, and I just clip a V in it, so it gives me a nice clear hold. So then that way, as you can see, when I've pulled my fabric away from my pattern, it's just interrupted it. If you go straight through the paper, straight through the fabric, and then in and out, I find that it tends to tear.
Yeah.
And so then you've lost your pattern, really. So, again, it's just about making those patterns last longer.
It's a tiny little tip like that that suddenly means that actually you can use that material again.
That pattern again
on your material. Now, talking of material, this is the material that we're using today. I'm going to go and see it.
Do it.
Yeah. I'll be back in a minute. Because here's the thing. When we bundle material for you, we can bring it to you at, we can bring it to you at a better price, and we can also take the hard work of deciding what colours go with what out of it. So here we go. These are the two different colours that we've put together for you. So we believe these go beautifully together. As you can see from the photos that we've had, they are absolutely gorgeous. So you're saving 10% on this. So $36.95 for all of this. AGGC 48. Now, when I say all of this, what we're looking at is 2 metres of both fabrics, which looks like that.
That's a lot of
that. Is a lot of fabric, okay? So that's from the floor up, that's your 2 metres of fabric, and you get that in both. It's a lot of fabric, isn't it?
A lot of fabric in
there. Yeah. Hello. So there we go. That's your 2 metres in both. So 4 metres of fabric in total for $36.95. That gives you 2 jackets. I don't know about you, but jackets, I've paid a lot of money, a lot more than $36.95 for 1 jacket, let alone one that I can turn inside out and effectively have 2. So, you know, happy days for me. This is lovely. I do love a nice jacket. Whoops, there we go. So that's one colour option. That is down... Oh, no, hang on. Yeah, this is your pyramids bundle. which is just there for you. So $36.95, AGGC 48. Get myself all discombobulated. If you want the pattern, that's down the bottom. Oh, it disappearing. Let's get on to the next fabric. Now, the reason why we've bundled these is because we can see on... we're not having to look on a screen to see whether or not colours go like you are at home. So look at that. Ah, yes. So the richness of this beautiful purple that then goes with this opulent goldy, greeny colour coming through here. But what you've really got to see with this fabric is the repeat of it, because it's stunning. And it is a head-turner. This is an absolute head-turner. If you're shy and retiring, these might not be the fabrics for you. But if maybe you like cruises and things like that, then look. Oh, just look at that.
I just love it.
So it's 114 centimetres in width, and you're getting 2 metres of it. That's a bit special.
Delicious.
Do you know, maybe that's the way to go. You know, if you go on a cruise and you need to dress for dinner, then you've got two jackets in one, haven't
exactly.
you?
Exactly, let's pack in.
Yeah. Reversible. It's a lot of fabric, isn't it?
Garments are just the way forward in my mind.
Do you know what?
Like everything reversible. I
remember having a Pink Panther reversible top when I was a kid and absolutely loving it. Here we go. That's your purple that's going with that. So that's another option for you. And then the last one. Oh, love this one. It's probably, yeah, it's my favourite. So, only because these are my kind of colours. But I know, Jennifer, that your favourite was the one that we just looked at, isn't it?
I do love that golden mustard colour, but I do love the bloom that you've got in front of you.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
It's beautiful.
So this is your bloom colour. Matched with a darker teal there. Look at that. It just works, doesn't it? There we go. So $36.95 for 4 metres of fabric, two of each. ASGC 52. Beautiful. So this is your Joel Dewberry Deco Bloom fabric. Oh, just divine. Look at that. There's something quite peaceful about it. So it's got that Art Deco inspiration behind it, but there's a cleanness and a crispness about it that I absolutely love, with your shades of teal and aqua in there. You've got some sunshine yellow and that grey in there as well. So $36.95, ASGC 52. Now, maybe if you are just buying the fabric bundles because it's a great deal on a huge amount of fabric, then actually, if you mixed and matched it, then that grey that we've got with the pyramid bundle, of course, as we can see from that, works beautifully as well. Ah, which to do? Which to do?
Delicious.
Which to do?
Which to do? Okay, so I've gone ahead and done some darts, but I didn't want to move on any further so I can show you what I've been
doing. Yeah, do you know what? This is always a little bit magic to me.
Bit of magic. Okay, so I've placed my pattern over two layers of fabric. So I cut once.
Right.
But you have two pieces.
Yes, okay. And we've got a tailor tack that we have got on the bottom and on the top piece of fabric.
Yeah, because we made sure we went through both layers, didn't we?
Yes.
So what you need to do now, so you're not doing anything with this, you're leaving it. As you are separating your layers, it will begin to stop. And that's where the loop has gone. Don't pull anymore because you're going to start pulling out your tack. Okay, so I've got two pieces of red. So I'm going to go in with my scissors and just make a little cut. So now I have two identical tailor's tacks in exactly the same place, ready for my next step.
So you're not going to get wonky darts, because let's face it, that's...
You might have wonky other ones, but... I know I have, but you won't have wonky darts. That's
no wonky darts.
No wonky
so
darts.
So your jacket's going to fit beautifully.
Exactly.
Yes.
So once we've got our points, so you rightly picked up on our notch in the side of our side seam here with this kind of triangle shape, and then obviously our point of darts. So this is where we're going to be pressing our darts in place. So what I would do is bring your fold together, so you've got your right sides together, okay, and then bring that notch there, that cut... Can you see? Into the crevice of where that triangle ends, okay?
Yeah.
That's the first thing. And then
then find out where your point of your dart is. And I know where that is because of my red tailor's tack there. So that's my dart. So some people just go in and do with a pin, but I find pressing this in is much better than than pinning in place would be.
Okay.
Okay. So I know that's in position and I know that's correct. So I'm just going to get my nice hot iron, press my dart in place. Okay. So I can see that I've gone over my dart just a little bit.
And that doesn't matter because you can always iron it out again.
Yeah, because I'm going to press it out. So there's the red tailor's tack there, and I've actually pressed about an inch over because I want that point to be super sharp.
Okay.
So I've done that first. So that almost acts like a pin in itself. That is really not going to be going anywhere.
No.
Okay. And then the next tip that I would say is to make sure that you are sewing in the right line. I would grab yourself one of your rulers.
In this case, I'm using my quilter's ruler.
And some tailor's chalk. So I'm just going to grab the blue so
now,
you can see it.
I only just twigged the other day with these tailor's chalks. And they're very inexpensive to pop in your basket. But you've got a little brush to brush them off.
Yeah. Clever, isn't it?
On the lid.
Super clever. I mean, if you've got tailor's chalk at home, then obviously it will wash out. Like you say, you can quickly give it a nice little rub with your little brush. So can you see my blue mark there?
Yeah.
Yep, perfect. So you don't have to go in with your tailor's chalk, but I find that if you want to perfect your darting skills, then I think it's always worth just giving it a quick...
$3.95 for your... that's not the pencils. That's for your vanishing... That's for your vanishing
just
marker.
Just as good.
But that,
just
that
as
works
good.
As well. But if you want... That's for one pen. If you're after these pencils, then they're on the website. So, Producer Paul, that's not what you've got up on the screen. There you go.
It's nice to have an array of colours because not everything will show up. There's no point using white tailor's chalk on this. You're not going to see it, whereas the blue popped instantly, so I knew exactly what I was doing. So once you've
They're on the website, take a look.
Once you've pressed your dart...
Yes.
And also drawn your stitch line, which is what that blue line is. I now can go to my machine.
Okay.
And I've also got another tip for you.
Okay.
Okay. So we're going to start at the wider part of the dart first.
Right.
Okay. So we're going to come in here. So again, I'm just going to line up. So if you hadn't have drawn the chalk at all, then what you would need to do is concentrate on your tailor's tack part here. Okay, so then what you would do is sort of angle it around to make sure that my thumb is in front of my sewing machine foot, which this is quite a large dart.
Yeah,
so this is why I think it's always worth drawing that line in. Okay, so that's the first one. So I'm going to go in with my normal stitch length. I'm just going to do a quick reverse at the side seam there. I'm going to come down. So I'm following my blue chalk line, and as I get about a sort of inch away, reduce your stitch length.
Really? What's that doing for me then?
Well, it's giving you a tighter stitch, and then it should give you a nice tight point.
So do you have to go forwards and back? And
you shouldn't need to with that, really, because I've
tighter.
Literally gone down to one. It's like the smallest of stitch. I don't even know if you could see that. It's the tinkiest of tiny stitches.
No,
it's almost like
it's
knotting
tiny.
As it's going.
Wow.
So then once you open that out, you can see I've got my little tailor's points there, so you should be able to pull these out nicely now. Or not, because I've stitched over with that beautiful small stitch. This is where you need your little unpicking.
At least you
it?
Know that you you went right on point.
Right on point. So just make sure you're not pulling anything else out, just your tailor's tack.
So this is your Joel Dewberry pyramids. You've got three different options for your fabric bundles today. You're getting 4 metres of fabric in each of the bundles, and it's 2 metres of each. So we've matched this with a lovely grey. So you're saving nearly 10% on here today, $36.95, AGGC 48. That is a good dart.
Gives you a nice dart. So we're not quite finished yet, because last thing we need to do now, if I just fold this over for you, the direction of the dart needs to now go down the body. So this is where you need to get your pressing skills
Why does it go down?
Because you don't want to go in your armpit.
Okay, fair enough.
So you're pressing it down, and then also you want to work the iron into that point area as well, into that point. So again, removing any creases. So I'll just do that very quickly and show you before and after.
So AGGC 48 gives you your pyramid bundle. Down the bottom there is the pattern. So this is the pattern. And again, you know, different feel. You can see on the front there, in a completely different fabric. Good. looking good, whichever way. This is the joy of it, isn't it? Once you've got this pattern, you can really do it in all the colours that suit you.
Oh, loads.
Different beautiful fabrics that we sell. Absolutely gorgeous. AGGC 48. It's basically two jackets in one.
It is.
It's reversible. That makes me so happy.
And you're onto something with the whole holiday cruise thing. Because, you know, it's you want to leave some space in your bag for duty free.
Absolutely, the important stuff. So we go day to night with this. So wear maybe the more conservative side for office wear. And then drinks with the girls after whatever. Change it around. Looking good. Or maybe it's just that you love to have a bit of a funky lining. Or whichever way around you want to do it, entirely up to you. Maybe you want to make it as Jenniffer did with the one that we have on the show today, where both sides are gorgeous patterns and then you've got a really striking binding on it. Now, if you do want to make the binding yourself, then we've got the bias binder maker, which now this is the 25mm bias binder maker, and that's the size binding that it recommends in the pattern. So if you don't want to buy your binding and you want to make your binding, then this is the 25mm one there.
This is the tool for you.
It is, isn't it? Because then you can do the binding in the colour that you want. You're not having to pay extra. $11.95 for your 25mm. Now, this is 25mm is generally what clothes makers, dressmakers would use.
Yeah.
But then the smaller one, which is the 12mm one that we've also got on the show, that I believe is for finer fabric.
It would be for finer fabrics or delicate necklines. It's always about the look. Sometimes you just want a thinner, you don't want a larger, get your words out, Jen, bias binding. Why am I struggling with that word?
No.
Sometimes you don't want that. So you just want with the finer fabrics, the really finer one, you wouldn't want a really bulky binding on that,
so
would you?
Where
so that's
one
perfect.
Would be great.
So it's always worth having the different sizes because the different thing, you would need them for different things.
Once you've got it, you've got it. Yep. It's a one-off payment, isn't it, for your bias binder maker? But then it means that you're never going to struggle to find the right binding.
And you'll save your fingers too.
Absolutely.
And time, which I know all of us struggle with.
And of course, grab the pattern because, you know, it's up to you what bias binding. You can buy bias binding off the website if you want, but if you want to make your own, then you can. So this is $12.95 for your pattern. Let's just take a little look here.
We can see from the instructions here with how you're laying out your fabric, you've got plenty of fabric left over to make your bias out of the fabric that you're buying with us today anyway.
Nice.
So it's always, I like to make my own bias. I very rarely buy bias, actually. I just make my own, yeah.
Excellent. So it even gives you those ironing instructions there.
Yeah, bias binding tips. I can say bias binding now. I've got my teeth in.
Yay! Perfect.
So I use on the jacket, I use the mitered corners. So the instructions for the mitered corners in my jacket, which is lovely.
We are making the boxy reversible jacket, and that's the pattern, $12.95. If you look at the bottom, then the bloom fabric, of which that is most prominent. And that's actually coming in a bundle with gorgeous dark teal.
Beautiful.
It's a real rich teal. Saving around 10% with this.
Gorgeous.
The fabric bundle. And that's what we can do, you know, when we start bundling fabrics, when you start to buy quantities of fabric like that, 4 metres of fabric, you know, that's...
And the discounts.
Yeah. Yeah, that's 8 units of fabric there.
It's always about the bargain.
Yeah.
It's always about the bargain.
Yeah. There you go.
Okay, so before we move on from the dart, so you can see that I've left a little bit of length on my thread there. So I've used the white thread, so I just put my hand in front of it so you can see. So we've got a little length on there. What I would suggest do, rather than clipping that, I would actually get a needle and thread that through the body of the dart.
Because you want to wash and wear this.
Yeah. So then that thread has to work all its way back up just to even get to the end of my point of my dart. So definitely thread that back through at that point.
Would you knot it?
If you want to be super secure. In theory, your smaller stitches should be almost doing that knotting for you anyway. But yes, if you want to belt and braces, as they say, give it a little knot. So separate the threads, do a single double knot, making sure that is close to the dart point. And then fold the remaining, and I've left about a good inch and a half on there, thread all of that back through the length of your dart, so that acts like a second knot in itself anyway.
So we really secure.
Okay, so we've got our left piece, which is the front section I've just folded over, and we've got our back piece, which I've gone ahead and done the two shoulder darts already. So again, the same process, exactly the same, but this time they're in an unusual place. You've probably not seen that before in the shoulder.
Do you know, you're right, I haven't actually. I haven't seen that before.
Like I say, go and check your jackets. So now I'm going to sew the shoulder seams in and a side seam in, because I really wanted to get onto the what I think a lot of people get worried about, which is a sleeve insertion. So I'm going to really spend some time with that on there. So we've got our dart here, and you can see where the two fabrics meet. And I've also got a notch on the top of my front piece as well. Now you need to line that notch up with the dart in the back.
Okay.
So don't worry about this overlap section here, because when you sew your 1.5, that will be the meeting point. So if you make your own bias binding, you'll be aware of the two triangles that go like that, and you sew down the middle of the triangle. It's exactly the same process here, okay? So I'm just going to stitch that in place. I'm going to speed ahead and not bother pinning it. But you get the point, don't you? So again, just remember, this isn't the same pattern as the earlier show. So this is a 1.5.
Metre and a half, 1.5 centimetre.
Metre and a half seam allowance, amazing.
That would be a big one, wouldn't it? And of course, that's the very first thing it tells you here, is that your seam allowance is 1.5 centimetres. It's the first thing that these cloth kits patterns give you. So thrilled to see cloth kits back again.
I used to.
Every Saturday morning, I used to go for my piano and my dance lessons. Thanks, Mum, for taking us along to that. And my piano teacher, Mrs. Hazel, she had a particular favourite, which was one of my cloth kits dresses. So my mum always used to put me in my cloth kits dress on a Saturday to go for my piano lesson.
So she'd be nice to you in the class.
Yeah. Now, we've bundled fabric for you so that you can make your own cloth kit, gorgeous, boxy, reversible jackets. This is how we've done it. So this is your Deco Bloom fabric. You've got aquas in there, you've got teals in there, and it is matched beautifully there with that dark teal in there. So that's $36.95 ASGC 52. The next one, oh yeah, this is your pyramids. So again, we've done the hard work for you, we've matched the fabrics. And you're saving nearly 10% on this, $36.95, AGGC 48 there. And really, that sort of charcoal-y colour makes that teal pop on that.
Really does.
I like a lot. And then the final one, because we've got three options for you. I love this. Love this. Look at that. Gorgeous pattern. The patterns in all of these are Joel Dewberry. So this is your bizarre fabric bundle, and I just love how we've put that opulent purple with that really, really regal. It's lovely.
Royal. It feels royal.
It does feel royal. It's a golden green. Is the best way to describe it. It's really hard on a screen to actually get the colours right.
Yeah, mustard. It's not a mustard.
No,
it's definitely not
a
mustard.
No,
it would probably be in
there.
The mustard section, but it's not mustard.
It's going to
suit
yellowy your colouring perfectly. On a blonde, for me, I need one of these.
Yeah,
I need
yeah.
one of the teals. But yeah, perfect for, it's
just
dark colourings.
And I really like that you've gone bold with the purple. I like that you've done that, because that's exactly what I would have gone for that colour.
Yes. Message for Diane, even. Please give us a call. It's free, 0800 112 4433, and then you can check the stocks with our call centre.
There you go.
Right, what's next?
Right, okay, so you've been showing the gorgeous fabrics, I've gone ahead and sewn my shoulder seam in.
Mm-hmm.
I've also gone ahead and done my side seam as well.
Okay.
So now we've got a hole. We've got a hole, which is where our sleeve's going to go, okay? So once you've done that, we are now going to take our sleeve shape. All right, so again, unusually, we've got a nice little shoulder. Well, it's actually not a shoulder at all. It's an elbow shape. And what that does, it just gives your sleeve just some shape, so it just kinks forward a little bit.
Nice.
So it's just a nice bit of tailored shaping.
It's a nice touch, isn't it?
It is a very nice touch. Okay, so again, I've sewn that, and I've pressed it down the sleeve, okay. Not up the sleeve. Mm-hmm. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to do some temporary stitches in here. And in order to get a nice sleeve insertion, we're going to be doing some gathering stitches here, or ease stitches.
Okay.
So the first thing you need to do is grab your machine, and you need to give it the longest thread it will give you. So the longest stitch it will give you. So on this one, bop, 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 that's giving me a 5.
Ooh.
Okay, so again, going back to our little hieroglyphics, you notice we've got a notch. We've got the front notch here, which I know that because it was on the front of the pattern.
Yeah.
And then we've got two notches here, which is indicating the back.
So one there, two there, and then that there.
That one there, okay. And what we're going to do, if you just stay there for me, darling, I'm going to start, and I'm going to sew around the head of the sleeve. We're not going to bother going into the underarms here, which is what those are. I'm going to literally just sew
there.
Notch to notch. And I'm going to do two lines of stitching. I'm going to do one at 1.5 first.
Okay.
And then I'm going to do one at what would be just under, just over half a centimetre.
Okay, why the two?
So, what that's going to do, if I talk as I'm stitching this, and by giving us the two channels of stitching, that's giving us a sort of gully, for lack of a better word.
Right.
For us to, where we're going to stitch. Because the sleeve head is a little bit bigger than the armhole.
Right.
So what we need to do is gather. You know when we did on the first hour, we did that curved edge and I pulled it and then it went like that. That's what you, if you think about your sleeve, that's what it needs to do in that area. If not, it will just pull.
Yeah.
So you'll find that on badly made garments or cheaper garments, that they've not allowed for that extra shape in the shoulder, so it just falls funny and it all feels like it's pulling.
Yeah.
It's because there's not enough fabric in that sleeve head to give you the shape.
Okay.
So I've just done one line of stitching first using the 1.5 and I've made sure I've left myself a decent bit of thread, because we're going to need to pull that in a minute. Okay, so you can see there's my stitch, there's my thread. Okay, so now I'm going to go back in again.
But these instructions in the kit as well,
I believe it does say to
me, have a look, we've got bias binding tips.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there we go.
They only do one, and that's perfect, that's not a problem. But I find doing the two layers of stitching, like giving you this gully,
so
a little bit better.
That's your long stitch.
That's right. So the step is in the instructions, but this is just an extra tip. So I'm going in now with my second row of stitching, and I'm using my original stitch line as my seam allowance guide with the edge of my foot
here. Okay, so the initial one was a centimetre and a half out.
It was 1.5 out. Yeah. And now I'm using the edge of my sewing machine here.
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter which side you want to use, either the edge of the foot here or the edge of the foot there. But I'm just doing a second line. And I've also just slightly decreased my stitch length on this one.
Right. What's that doing for us?
So again, let me just get to this point, and I'm just going to pull, give myself a nice length.
Yeah.
And we're done. Okay. So,
many questions.
Questions are good. Questions are good. So, we have the biggest stitch here, and then we have the smaller but still long stitch there. Okay. So, what's going to happen is when I do this, this has got a bigger surface area than that side, hasn't it? So if I do a bigger stitch here, that gives me a big gather.
Right.
This one's going to give me an even smaller gather. So it just helps in that process.
So larger one there, that's on your seam allowance of a centimetre and a half.
Yeah, that's right.
And then sort of midway is one which is slightly smaller.
Just a smidge.
So you can just start to see
those. It's still not good enough. That size length isn't good enough for a standard stitch because they're too big a gap. So they're still gathering, but the rates at which they gather are different. So I'm just going to pull this now.
Okay. Now the final thing that this is going to look like, the final product, if you will, that this is going to look like is this. So you get the pattern for $12.95, SGCY80, and then your pyramid fabric bundle, $36.95. You're going to get 2 metres of the beautiful Joel Dewberry pyramids fabric, which is the one that you can see there, and then that striking grey that you've got, which just makes that pattern go pop.
Ta-da! I love that pyramid one. It's great, isn't it? Super great. Okay, so I've pulled my threads. You don't have to pull them too much, but you can see that I've got a nice curve on the first line of stitching, and then the second line, which I did at the slightly tighter one, is pulling it in a little bit tighter than the top layer.
Do you just pull from the one side, or do you pull from both?
I would
tees from both sides.
Okay.
Tees from both sides. You can, but then you have to distribute your gathers.
Yeah.
So, so you want to create a very small ripple. You don't want a gathered skirt here. Like okay. It's just okay. about, like you, the word is easing that little sleeve head there, so you've got a nice curved shape. But that smaller stitch is just giving it a little bit more tension in that area, which is where you probably find that you start, when you sew your sleeve on, you'll end up with gathers, okay? So that's the first thing. I've gone ahead and done that straight away. So now I'm going to make my sleeve before I then insert it.
Yeah.
Okay, I just find it easier to do it now rather than trying to work with it while it's in a tube.
Yeah, no, you can see the shape already, can't you, coming through.
Cool. So now that I'm creating the sleeve, so I'm putting my right sides together, I'm going to sew down the length of the stitch. So just make sure you put your stitch back.
Oh, yeah, no, don't, yeah.
Make sure you put your stitch back, that's the important thing.
So, do you know, I'm really impressed at how quickly this comes together.
It's a great, it looks complicated with the binding and the fact it's reversible, but it's just two jackets stitched together and then finished off with a lovely binding. That's it. You can do it. You can do it.
Absolutely do it. So let's take a look. We've got, if you want to make this, then now This is the finished article. We've got a slight variation with the colours here. So if you would like to finish that, we finished that one in grey, but if you'd like to finish it with the teal, that's the bundle that we've got, that beautiful deco bloom by Joel Dewberry there, and matched with the deeper teal, works perfectly together. $36.95. That is 2 metres of each of those fabric. That's 4 metres in total, which is enough to give you your inside and your outside. So this is going to give you your reversible jacket, two jackets in one, for $36.95. ASGC 52. Now if you want to go for the pyramid, then there we go, then you're getting that grey. That's the grey that we just saw on the jacket previously, but this grey just makes
pop,
this sort of aquary teal. Absolutely pop. I don't know what your screen's like at home. It's really difficult to get the right colour, because on our screen that looks really bright, but it's
about your contrast dark at home, isn't it? How you
absolutely. And then this one here, this is your regal, opulent one, isn't it? And this is the bizarre fabric. We've teamed it with that gorgeous, rich purple there. And this is your bizarre fabric, XKGC20. Oh, I want to be able to wear that colour.
You can. Oh, no.
I think I might be able to get away with it because of the purple trim.
Oh, it's just might gorgeous.
Work. Might work.
Okay. Sorry, I've stitched my... This is why we're talking about notches, and it's really important to pay attention to them. So I've got my sleeve over here, and I've opened up my jacket. So I've not sewn my other side. That's my left side. No, right side, sorry. So I'm working with the left at the moment. So you can see this is the shoulder seam.
Do you label them? Because this is something I hadn't even thought of.
Well, technically it is labelled, but when I looked at that, I've not looked at it properly and labelled it incorrectly, as you do. So it wouldn't be a problem if I'd gone ahead and sewn the other side, because I'd just go, oh, that's not the right one, I'll just flip it. But this is what I'm going to show you at home. So
okay.
I only sewed my one side. At home you would have sewn both.
Yes.
So I've got my shoulder seam here, my side seam there, and I've got my arm scythe there. Okay. Mm-hmm. So now with your sleeve...
Your arm what?
Arm scythe. It's a circle part of your arm. Scythe. I think it's S-Y-C-E, scythe. I might have said it wrong because I'm from the Black Country, but you never know. Anyway, okay, so now you've got your sleeve. I've sewn it together, so we have a sleeve.
Yes.
I just need to attach it to my body. Okay. So make sure you turn it so it's the right side facing each other. Okay, so again, that sometimes you end up getting confused with that. So you do need to turn it out so how you would wear it is how you see it, okay? So I'm going to place my seam next to my underseam. So that's the first thing.
This is always part of your jigsaw, isn't it?
It's all part of your jigsaw. So this is where I realised, oh, I have to do it the wrong way. So here, you can see on this side, I've got a single notch. On this side, I've got a double notch. So this sleeve needs to go into that side of my garment, not this one.
Ah.
So it needs to go here.
Okay.
So I'm going to sew that super, 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 super quick.
Right, let me tell you then about the pattern, how to get that pattern. SGCY80 gets you this pattern. It's from Cloth Kits. I'm so pleased that they are back on the radar again. I don't know where they've been. Maybe they have still been around for the last 30 years, but here we go. Full pattern in there. And let me just have a look at the instructions for you. And of course, as Jennifer is very taken with these, because they come with a proper paper pattern, the thick paper pattern for you. So you can trace it, you've got it there to use. But of course, the instructions, really clear, very simple, very easy to use. And you're getting a reversible jacket, two jackets in one. Nice. And of course, this is what it's going to look like. There. And if I just give you the details, because that's the bloom print. Now, in the picture, it's got a darker trim, but we've matched it with this darker teal. So this is $36.95. ASGC 52. I would love it. Those of you that have bought the fabric bundles today, I would really love to see the finished. You wearing it.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Inspire us. Show us.
Well, you're making a saving as well in buying the bundle. You know, we can do that when we start to bundle fabrics and sell, you know, 4 metres in one go. So you're going to get around 10% off there. Right, so.
So now I've got the sleeve in the right way.
Yay!
Yes. Okay. So you can see I've got a double.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got a double.
Mm-hmm.
Which means we're in the right place.
Yay!
So I'm placing that together.
That's why your notches are so important.
Super important. So that's the first thing. So you might see that this side looks a bit tighter than that one. That looks a bit baggy. Okay, so this is where you need to ease it. So I find if you actually fold it over like that, you can see that it actually does fit.
Mm-mm.
It's just that when because that's the way it needs to go. Okay, so when you're pinning, try not to stretch. So definitely pay attention to your notches.
Right.
They're there for a reason. Don't try and push that out.
Right.
Because then you are going to end up with a big, big gather somewhere and you really don't want that. So I've gone ahead and pinned in my centre seam there, and mm-hmm. The side seam of my sleeve, up to the notches. That's the first section.
If you've over-gathered your sleeve, just don't tie them off so you can ease them out again.
You are definitely, 110% not knotting anything, and don't cut the threads either. You want nice long threads because you need to be able to work with them, okay? So now it's about getting this gathered area into my sleeve head. So that's the first thing. So if I work at the top of the sleeve into the top of the shoulder, which is that
section. And how do you know which is the top of the sleeve?
Well, I can see because the way I've gathered how it's sitting.
Mm.
Okay. So how it's, you can see there from your point of view. So if I flip it around there, you can just see from where I'm holding my sleeve that it's sitting that way. And that's where my my shoulder seam is. So I'm going to place that there.
Can we do this in a minute?
I can do it in a minute.
You can do it in a minute.
Okay. If I just show you the technique, that's the main thing. So now it's about getting this folded edge. You can see that even with that small adjustment that I've done already, it's almost sitting on top of each other.
Yeah.
So I just need to give it a little bit more of a pull. Nothing much more. Again, making sure that we are easing and not gathering. So you can see there is still a smooth edge there.
Mm.
And I also find that if you actually flip over your flat edge, which is going to be my shoulder seam, and let the sleeve head sit how it would sit, then I find pinning it in that way a lot easier.
Okay.
Another tip would be when you come to the sewing machine, sew with the gathers this side facing up so you can see what you're doing. So if you can see that you're sewing a pleat, stop, readjust, and carry on. That would be my tip for slipping insertions.
Amazing. Thank you so much. So this has been our boxy jacket, reversible jacket, of course. Don't forget that. The pattern is $12.95. We've put together fabric bundles for you. Take a look at those on the web because you are making a saving on those. Bonny is coming up next. Remember to check out your baskets so that you absolutely get everything that you need, love and require. Jennifer, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Lovely to see you. And I will see you,
soon.
When is that?
Sunday.
Yay! See you Sunday then. And see you in just one moment.
Follow us on Instagram. Search for our Sewing Quarter page and follow us to get our latest posts.
Here at the Sewing Quarter, we want to help you with your levels of sewing. Whether you're a novice or you've been sewing for years and years, we want this to be a fabulous learning curve for all of you. Whether it's making a little gift or making yourself a fabulous outfit, we will be working with some of the UK's biggest designers. You have to join us for that.
Don't forget, our sister brands are some of the leading brands in the industry, with Love Patchwork and Quilting being rated top modern quilt title on the market. Today's Quilter has achieved market leadership in the traditional quilt sector. And finally, Simply Sewing was launched in February 2015 after noticing a gap in the market for beginners. Combined, we reach over 150,000 readers every month. The Sewing Quarter is a new, inspirational sewing and quilting channel here to help educate our viewers with some of the best designers in the business. We hope to bring you some exciting demonstrations with some of the top industry experts. We're part of the Immediate Media family. Immediate Media is a fast-growing multi-platform company who operates some of the most loved brands across the UK. Our brands range from our first TV shopping channel adventure with Jewellery Maker to several successful magazines such as Simply Sewing, Radio Times, BBC Good Food and many more. We've been working incredibly hard to set up and bring you our new exciting channel, and we hope that we can help inspire you with new ideas and projects. Did you know there are multiple ways you can contact us, even if it's just to ask a question? Our friendly team are always on standby. You can call our customer service team at 0800 112 4433, email us at help@sewingquarter.com, visit our Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter at Sewing Quarter, and even message us through our website, and our presenters will answer your questions live on air.
Join us on Wednesday the 22nd of March for our Easter Bunny Bonanza on Sewing Quarter. We've been inundated with requests for the big-eared bunny soft toy kits, and we're delighted to announce that Joe Carter is bringing Bunny back with three new fabric choices just in time for Easter. So, join Joe and the Big-Eared Bunny on Wednesday the 22nd of March at 11 a.m, only on Sewing Quarter, Freeview Channel 78.
How long for? I don't know, because let's face it, Big Ear Bunny always goes quickly. Hello, welcome to the Sewing Quarter. Yes, he's back, Big Ear Bunny, which always feels, you know, a little bit personal. But he does indeed have big ears. He is back with friends. Oh, he's back in three different colours. So let's take a look at the colours that we can get him in. Now, this is your cream option. This is what he looks like in the cream. Oh, sort of. This is the cream material. But he comes with a pink body today. So our bunnies, but not as we've known them. So that's the material that you're getting. That's the Tilda material that you're getting. But it's coming with a pink body material. Lovely. So let's show you these. So in each of the kits, here we go. This is your cream bundle. Now, in each of these bundles, you'll get the stuffing as well. So you'll get... Yeah, that's a whole load. That's a whole load of bunny stuffing. Here we go. So for each of these, you get your two contrasting materials. You get your thread and you get your nose. So, yeah, you've got the embroidery thread, but then we're actually giving you thread as well that's going to go wadding and... What? All that wadding? No. Joe Card said that you could make at least three bunnies if you were very, very savvy about how you cut your material, potentially four, out of this. And you've got a whole load of wadding in there as well. Okay, now, here's the thing. This is always the catch, isn't it? stocks are not massive of these. We just cannot get these in quick enough for you, and they're gone. So this is your pink. That's your pink. £19.95, under £20 for these. So perfect for your Easter gifts. And then the next colour that we've got... Hang on, let me show you. Is the blue, this one? Now, we like to think of this little chap as being... Oh, he's down. Come on, Bunny, you can bounce back. I like to think of this as the retro bundle. Because you've got the ginger, you've got your teal and your blue in there. So this is your Tilda. This is from your Bumblebee range here. We've got a matching thread in there. Then you've also got your embroidery thread there for the nose. And then you've got your body. It doesn't matter which way around you do it. Full instructions coming with these as well. And your wadding and your stuffing. JMGC14 is your code for that. Can I just show you, actually, how much of this Tilda you're getting? Because this is... You get a lot. Look at this. That's half a metre of your Tilda material. It's a lot of material in there. Now, so that's your blue option. We've also got... okay, so the pink. Let me just show you the pink again. So the pink... Oh, I think the pink was what I showed you thinking it was the cream. Sorry, I've showed you the wrong one. Okay, so if you're after the pink, that's the pink. You see, let me just check. Producer Paul, because there's cream in both of these bundles, is it pink as in that's the pink? Okay, so this is the one that makes it the pink bundle. My apologies, I went with this being cream. So £19.95 for your pretty in pink. MPGC13, again from the Bumblebee Tilda range. So your pattern material is always your Tilda. Do check out your baskets because they are going quick. Let me show you the cream, okay? This is my apologies for this, okay? I got it round the wrong way. This is your cream. So you get your gorgeous tealy coloured Tilda here with a beautiful, oh, just stunning. There's your bumble. You see, it's the Then you get your plain colour there, your sort of biscuity, creamy colour there for the body. This is your cream. So when you're choosing which one to go for, if it's cream, then it's this colour that we're going by. This is your cream. The other has the pink body, so that's the pink. And then the blue has that. So here we go. You also get, with each of these, wadding and stuffing. So the whole lot for £19.95. This is an incredible price. NJGC41. You are going to have to check out your baskets on these really, really quickly. The best way is to call us up. They will sell out, so please do the rush on these already. They've already sold out twice before, so... Oh, please do grab them quick as you can. £19.95, NJGC41. Well, all of them. They can't. Now, so the cream already gone.
Already?
Please call her. We've brought bigger stocks than we've ever had.
Well, it is nearly Easter, I suppose.
We cannot multiply these bunnies quickly enough, can we?
No.
Wow, okay.
I can't believe that.
So if you wanted the cream, please check out your basket. Otherwise, I think it's sold out. Okay, let's have a look at the blue. You're demoing the blue, aren't you, today?
Yes, my walkthrough one is the blue.
Okay.
So there's a blue ear.
You get, within these, you're going to get full instructions, wadding, stuffing, beautiful Tilda material, half metre of your Tilda material, and the contrasting fabric to do the rest of the body with. Where do we start?
I like to start with all the components that get added into seams.
The extremities.
The extremities, yes. So first ears and then I'll go on to limbs.
Okay.
But the front of the ear is made up of two parts. The back of the ear is one complete piece.
Now, we were talking about this, weren't we? This is Jenniffer Taylor's favourite one because of the retro kind of colouring.
Yes.
So we've tried to go for all tastes.
All bases are covered. Yeah. Although... possibly not quite enough.
So JMGC 14 for your Bonny blue, big eared Bonny bunny and blue. They just want to make life easy for us to say, don't they? Do you know what, actually, what I haven't showed you, what I'm just going to run and grab, okay, are the instructions. Did you write all these instructions yourself, Jo?
I did. I mean, they were edited by somebody that made sense of them, but I did originally write the...
They were translated by someone else. but these are yours. Now, 10 years in the toy-making industry.
Yes.
For you. And this is why you are so good at your job, because you come up with gorgeous things such as Big Ear Bunny. Now, you'll notice he's in a different colourway. He first showed his little head in Simply Sewing magazine.
I think he's been in two magazines. I think he's
has
been
he? In... He gets lo- around in the nicest has. Possible way.
Very early on, he was in Love Patchwork and Quilting, and then...
But
he's been, of all my designs, I think possibly he's been the most popular.
He's just gorgeous. Now, my producer's trying to tell me something, but he's really quiet. Right, OK. Please give us a call, because stocks are at bare minimum again. I'm so sorry. We've tried to get as many as we can, and... if you've just popped them in your basket, you haven't got it guaranteed, please make sure that you check out your baskets. It's happening again. Deja Vu Bunny is what I'm going to start calling him. So we've tried our hardest to bring you... Well, it's the fabric. It's getting hold of enough of the fabric that's the problem.
Yes.
Because obviously we team it with a beautiful Tilda fabric. We want to give you the top quality fabrics to go with it. So, that's been the problem. So... We've got as much as we can for you. We apologise if you've missed out. We will keep bringing him back until you've got him. You will get him. We will try as much as we can. So, ears.
Yeah, we'll start with the ears.
I love the international symbol for ears.
So we have... The front is done. I've just stitched straight across the top of the ear.
Yeah.
Onto the bottom. And in the pattern, because the bottom of the ear looks almost symmetrical, but it isn't.
Right.
There are markers on the pattern, so you definitely get this piece on the correct way onto the bottom.
Right.
And then we want to put it on top of a back ear piece.
Now, how does the sandwich go? Because wadding is required, isn't it, for the ear?
It is. So you put them right sides together, back ear and front ear together, and then on top of a piece of wadding. And then we're just going to sew all around the edge, leaving the bottom end open.
Okay.
So I'll go for that.
Okay. Please do check out your baskets. Don't check out your baskets. Call. It's now down to calling to make sure that you secure one. So even if you've got it in your basket, it's not secure, please do call to confirm that you've absolutely got your bunny. I apologise for this. You know, we can only bring you as many as we can get our little mittens on. So 800-112-4433 is our free phone number. It's a UK call centre number. It's free to call. And all of our call centre people are in the UK. So please do give them a call. 0800-112-4433 to secure your bunny, and then you've definitely got it. If it's just sitting in your basket, it's not definitely yours until you've either checked out or rung that number. Okay, so ringing is the best way, and it's not like we make any money from the call centre or anything like that. It is just in there. So 0800-112-4433. Whilst you stitch around the edge of that ear.
Yep.
And what seam allowance are we using, just as a quick question?
Quarter of an inch. So 6 millimetres.
Okay.
But that's marked in the pattern.
Okay,
all right. It'll be in the pattern notes.
Excellent.
So we've stitched around the ear.
Right.
I'm going to trim away now the excess. Okay.
We've had a message from Peggy.
Hello, Peggy.
She's a beginner. Hello, Peggy. She said what, sorry? Where do you sew for seam allowance? And so, that's what I just asked. How big was the seam allowance, really?
So if a quarter inch foot on a machine is great, because then you can use the edge of the foot. But often there'll be a mark, even if the foot's a little bit wider, there'll be a mark to follow. So just a bit of practice.
To know your machine, isn't it? Every machine is different.
It is.
And you'll find on your machine or quarter of an inch foot. So that, but it is a quarter of an inch seam allowance. But it is written in the instructions. Let me just find those for you. I'm not even sure. Oh, hang on. I've got it all around the wrong way. Here we go. You will need, there we go, notes. Okay, all seam allowances are 5 millimetres, so a half a centimetre, unless otherwise noted. So very clear in the instructions there for you.
Okay. So when we've sewn around the ear, we need the tip to turn.
Mm-hmm.
And this makes it easier to stuff that ear round, doesn't it?
It does. It just takes, because you've got more fabric here that you're trying to fit into this space, and it will just become chunky.
Okay.
So we want to get as smooth a line as possible. So I'll just...
These scissors, obviously, great for the job. You want a pair of scissors that are going to cut all the way to the tip, and that's exactly what these done. Not only do they look beautiful with that rose gold colouring there, just stealing your snips.
Those are the ones.
But also, do you know what? Form and function. I say this time and time again with these scissors. 16.95, 21 centimetre premium dressmaking shears. I thought they were just going to be pretty. I thought they were a fad and I thought they were just going to be pretty. I was proved so wrong. The first time I picked them up, and they absolutely sharp from all the way along that, the length of its blade, is absolutely fabulous. To be able to snip like that, not many scissors can manage that.
No, those are the ones I ordered for my mum.
Are they?
Yes.
Does she know?
She has them now. They were for Mother's Day, but it was her birthday beforehand, and I was...
stockpiling the gifts.
So I gave them to her for it. She knew about them, so she had them for her birthday.
So your mum sews as well?
She does.
Is that how you learnt?
Yes.
Well, for which we're very grateful. So EYGQ871695. Now, ear is inside out, and then quilting?
Give it a little press first, only a light press. Don't want to compress the wadding too much, but it does make it look a bit easier when you quilt the ear, if it's just that little bit flatter.
Okay.
There we go.
Both sides?
Yes, both sides, I think. Cool.
There we go.
With the new iron.
Joe, are you with us all week?
I'm not, no. Today.
Were you here yesterday?
I was here yesterday, yes.
Ah, you made a cat. Oh, you made the cat, didn't you?
I made the cat door.
Did that sell out in record time as well?
It did sell out, yes.
Yes, it is the Joe factor, the Carter factor.
I'm rushing ahead.
Go on, where do we need to go?
Now we're going to quilt, and you can quilt the ears however you'd like.
Is this how we made it into patchwork and quilting, first of all?
Yes. Well, because originally I designed toys, toy making was work sewing, and hobby sewing was quilt sewing, and then I did some work full of patchwork and quilting. I thought, why not?
Merge
where I can combine the two. So that's what happened. Just going to use the air erasable marker. I've made a lot of these ears, so I would do it without marking them on first. But,
just for our shows. I mean, the number of times that they've sold out. I'm going to be able to make this bunny in my sleep, which is brilliant, because this means that every time I watch the shows, every time I do the shows with you, I'm learning every single time, which is going to give me the confidence to absolutely go for it.
If at any point
you actually leave one for me by the end of the show, which hasn't happened yet... Not yet. So whilst you quilt round those ears, okay. I am going to go and grab some books to look at as well. So you keep quilting, Jo. Round you go. Now, you've also brought us... Are you okay to chat and quilt?
I am.
Okay. You also bought us the whale, didn't you? The Shannon fabric whale the other day.
I did.
Producer Paul was off. He missed it. It was absolutely gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. And again, the pattern, I believe, came out of one of the Tilda books.
Well, I've done two whales. The Shannon one was one of my patterns.
Oh, that was
that I've
your
had
pattern.
In a magazine. But I also made from I think it was the Tilda Spring ideas. No, Seaside.
Was it the Seaside one?
I made a whale.
In this one.
And I'd never made a Tilda pattern before. And I love that whale that I made from the pattern.
So there's all sorts of... So we've got in here, obviously, we've got the beautiful... beautiful Tilda fabrics. So it seems only fair if you want to then have a look on our website, because on the website we also have got for you the Tilda books, which means that you can do the Tilda toys that are featured within the Tilda books, because the fabric is beautiful. So this is your spring idea, $7.95. just while Joe finishes off quilting that ear. Bless you, Joe Carter.
Sorry.
No, bless you. So again, full instructions. So, oh, there you go. Hey, you bought us... Did you do this one as well?
I made the bug.
Yeah, we did that one together, didn't we? The bug.
That was a cute little me.
Yeah. So once you've got your tool of fabric, because you will have left over if you managed to get hold of the bunny. If you didn't manage to get hold of the bunny this time, apologies. We will have to bring Bunny back again. He keeps coming back. But this is your spring ideas. Under £10 of stuff. I mean, this is my dream. Just beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And lots of ideas for gifts, for yourself, for decking out. You know, just whatever you fancy. And all of the patterns. There's the bug pattern there. All good in there. So £7.95 and you've got lots of different ideas. I think once you get the bug for making toys, you're going to keep going, aren't you? So if you want to have the spring ideas, it's £7.95. We've used these scissors as well. What do you do next, Jane?
I've quilted the ear.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a walking foot for your machine, always use it when quilting, but... This, I mean, I've done this with a regular foot, and because it's small and we've pressed it and it's all sandwiched together, it's fine to use a regular foot. So there we go. And then the next job with the ears to complete them is to fold the outside, so the slightly more curved edge in first, into about the centre, and then fold that side over, and then we just want to baste along the bottom to hold those folds in
and
place.
And do that within the seam allowance.
Within the seam
allowance. So that won't then be seen once he's sewn into the head.
We don't need to take these stitches out.
So. Okay. And it's as easy as that?
It is. Just whiz across the bottom with a few stitches. And it just holds it.
Do you snip as you go, those little loose threads?
Yes, I'd like to. I don't always. But I do get a bit fed up with threads if I don't do it. And the thread ends everywhere. And then at the end, you have to trim them out because they get caught in seams.
Look at that. Look at that. Perfect with that bee in the middle.
Well, you can fussy cut as well. If there's a particular motif in or design within the pattern you like, you can select it for the... So I made sure there was a bee in each.
Yeah, no, you do. You get a lot of fabric for your money with this. This is your... okay, so let's give you a quick update on where we're at with the bunnies. We've got down to there are only three left of the cream. That's why I'm saying please ring if you're after these kits. We've only got three. Does that mean everything, the other colours have all sold? Wow. Okay. So if you're after the bunny today, we've only got the cream now left and we've only got three of those. So please give us a call so that you don't miss out. We just can't bring you enough. I'm so sorry. 0800 112 4433. Bunny ears. Where do we go next?
Right, I've got the face pieces out, I'll do those in a minute, but the limbs, I have a selection of ready-made limbs on the trolley.
Excellent.
So there's three, but I will make
ready-made limbs on the trolley.
This is the top of the leg, or the, well, it's a limb because they're arms as well, and that's the bottom, so we're just going to sew them.
Looks slightly strange, doesn't it? Well, I can't just do two, can I? There you go. There. It looks like a chicken foot now, doesn't it?
It does.
That is one big chicken. Idea for future toys.
A mighty chicken.
A mighty chicken. Yes.
So I'll sew across there to...
Are all the legs done the same? Legs, arms, limbs, whatever you want to call them, they're all done the same?
They're made in exactly the same way. The only thing that changes is right at the end when I baste the end closed, once there's some filling in there.
Is that the direction?
Yes, it's the way. So there'll be, I think I've closed two there, one in each direction.
Yeah, so to show that, because the arms go down the side... I can't remember which way around it goes. So the legs, is it right? The legs get shut across the top.
With the seam flush to one side. Just as they're folded to make them.
So that's going to be the legs. So you can see there the seam just goes along there. But the arms, the seam is going to go down the side, down the centre.
It's so the sort of hand is shaped like that when it's joined in.
Oh, I love it. Okay.
So right. stitched across there, and then we want to fold them over lengthways and then sew down the side and around here. But instead of coming straight off, I'll draw it on for ease. Instead of coming straight round and off, so you get a little bit of a point, you just want to taper the end up just around it slightly.
So you don't want a pointy paw.
Just so we get a nice even curve.
Can I show that? Did we see that really nice and tight? So instead of coming out, you can see coming out to there, taper it through further and come up, and then you'll get that nice rounded paw, which is what we're all after.
It's all about the rounded paws.
It's all about the rounded paws, of course it is.
Okay, so I'll sew down there.
Do you ever get bored of making this bunny? Or is he just so cute?
I used to say I could only make a pattern 8 times.
Really? You've got a limit?
And then I get after eight, a little bit of boredom sets in. But actually, I've really enjoyed making this bunny in different fabrics each time because it...
He looks so different, doesn't he, in every single fabric?
He does, and they all have their own little sort of different personalities. Well, not actually. I don't really think they come alive or anything.
They're good bunnies, aren't they? And perfect for Easter. So congratulations if you managed to get yourself a bunny. Apologies if you haven't managed to get one this time. Hopefully we will be able to bring him back. Dream of a world where everyone has a bunny.
Should be hordes of them.
Yeah.
Right, so, sorry for reaching across. And then when we've done that, it's tapered up the seam, so we've got a nice curve on either side.
Do you have to snip again?
Yes, just V-shaped notches, taking care of the stitching. You don't want to clip your stitching at all.
OK. What would happen if you did?
You'd have to re-sew it, otherwise it would just come undone.
OK.
There we go.
And it's just around the curve that you need to clip?
Yes, okay. You can leave the side, then we'll turn it the right way out.
You need a bodkin.
I do, I saw those.
Haven't got you a bodkin, have we? They are on the website, and this is exactly the sort of project where a bodkin would be perfect.
Because Sammy swears by bodkins, doesn't she?
She does.
Actually, there's a few things I need to go on the website for. I want the storage boxes for the spools.
Yes. It's one of those things, isn't it, that so many of our designers, and this is what... I think this is what has surprised me more than anything else, is that since we came to Air, our designers, all experts in their field, but you've all seen things and gone, oh, I didn't know you could get that. Oh, yes. I didn't know that was a thing. And so everybody's still learning. It doesn't matter what level you get to, you still learn. It's brilliant.
And there are always new discoveries to make.
Do you like that iron?
The iron's fine. I don't think I've brought any toy stuffing on with me, but...
Would you like some? Because there's a great big bag of it over there.
I have a little bit of leftover wadding. I'll stuff this quickly with a bit of
Use a bit of wadding if needs be.
You can, but that toy filling is really good, the one that comes with it. Because some toy fillings, when you put them in, they compress and they become quite hard, but that one's got a nice amount of bounce to it, nice and soft.
You see, I didn't realise that was a thing. I thought you could just stuff with any old stuffing and it didn't matter. But it's not actually the case.
I do quite a bit of stuffing and I really notice the difference between...
Really?
Yes. I have my favourites when it comes to stuffing. I mean, doesn't everybody?
Well, no, you see...
I'm quite the connoisseur.
Well, no, it's I'm learning about different stuffings and I just assumed all stuffings were the same. So it's really interesting to hear you say that. But if you've bought the bunnies, then you've got the stuffing. Otherwise, do head to the website because there will be stuffing on there and wadding and all these sorts of things.
And also, when I'm stuffing, if I've got some stuffing, imagine this is toy stuffing out of the bag, I always give it a little pull apart just to fluff it up before I put it in. And I said that once on air, and I found my youngest son in the sewing room. I'm just fluffing up your stuffing for you. Well, thank you.
No, but it's not your youngest son that started sewing, is it?
No, that's
the elder one.
It is.
Is he still enjoying his sewing lessons?
He is. He's really enjoying it. So, in fact, I think that's today, lunchtime today.
Oh, is
it? He's doing some sewing, so I'll get to admire his handiwork later.
I think it's lovely when they do things like that.
It's, I love doing craft. I'm not so keen on the tidying up afterwards, but...
Now, if you're loving the Tilda fabrics that we've been bringing to you, we've got some other Tilda fabrics for you on the show. So maybe it's the fact that maybe you've already bought the bunny, you've been lucky enough to get the bunny, and now you want to make some extra things out of your Tilda fabric, then we've got a Fat 8 bundle for you. Now, this is your autumn tree. So this is $34.95, 14 pieces with this. And, of course, this is the joy, isn't it? Once you've got one of the Tilda books or you've got the bunny pattern, then you can really go to town. And this is a great way. If you want that beautiful Tilda quality, if you want the elegance and the shabby chic element that you get with Tilda, and it is undeniably Tilda when you see it, you're going to be getting 14 different pieces. If you don't know what a fat eighth is, it's half a fat quarter. And you'd get all the bunny extremities, wouldn't you, out of one of these? Easy.
Yes. I have a sneeze.
Oh, you sneeze.
I think it's disappeared.
Okay, so that's how...
Pretty much as you would expect, but the seam that joins from the nose down to the neck, you don't want to close that until you've got the back of the head on.
So the gullet. That's,
yes. You don't want to close that because... having that open is easier to join the back of the head on.
Right.
So that's the last thing you do on the head before you join it to the body. But it makes life more difficult if you close that, because you automatically look at it and think, oh, I'll sew that together. But no, it says in the instructions, but you need to leave that until last.
So what this is giving you shape?
Yes. So the little darts in the middle of the head, just at the top.
Mm-hmm.
So you just want to sew along that, taper it in.
And we're getting that. There we go.
How's that? Can you see?
So starting to give some shape there.
I'm going to add the sides on.
Okay.
And I always sew from the nose up each time. And it does mean for one side you'll have the middle face on the top when you're sewing, and then the other side you'll have the side face on the top for sewing. But for an even finish, I think it's worth sewing from the nose up each time.
Okay. It's these little top tips, isn't it, that can only come from someone that has been there, done it, and got the bunny. And if you've managed to get the bunny, congratulations, by the way, because he's proving to be quite tricky to get hold of and to keep in stock. So if you've managed to get hold of him, big congratulations there. How long ago did you design the bunny?
The bunny is one of my older designs. A couple of years, maybe.
Really?
I think so.
I don't think a bunny ever goes out of fashion, though.
It doesn't. I make them every Easter.
Do you?
Yes.
This one, or do you make changes?
This one, although, actually, I have a bunny pattern. There was a bunny pattern in last month's, the last issue of Simply Sewing.
Oh, really? So if you've got last month's Simply Sewing, you can make a different Joe Carter bunny, maybe grab yourself some of the Tilda fabric and bunny yourself up.
That one's a design that's more suited to plush fabric, so the Shannon.
Okay. All right. Don't grab the Tilda then for that. But grab the Tilda because it's pretty.
Tilda's
what are we doing
ideal
now?
For this one.
So now we're still going around the side of the head. So we're just putting all these head pieces together.
Yes, and then I'll base the ears in place and join the back of the head. So I'm going to start from the nose
so
again.
So that's the snout there, again, is it?
It is.
Okay. Is this... What level is this?
I would say this was an intermediate pattern. Not because there's anything... It's... The pieces are quite... A bit small, maybe, for a beginner pattern. But if you have the confidence to go for it, go for it. A lot of it is just confidence, because some of the terms and the jargon can be intimidating and things like that, but give it a go.
But if you've seen him, and this is the thing, isn't it, now? We've seen him be made a couple of times now, so for me, that gives me the confidence to go, yeah, you know, actually, I can really do this.
So there we go. I've joined the... sides of the face on, but I'm going to leave this bit open for
so
a while.
So this is the centre of your head. There, the side darts to the face. And this is the gullet that you leave...
This bit here, the front of the face.
The gullety bit that you leave open. Do you stuff through that, or...?
No, I just... When I join the back of the head on, it's just easier to join it with that open, whereas it's a much tighter curve to get round if you've closed that off. So it's little things like that make it a bit easier.
Because this is a non... This part here is a non-directional fabric. and it's just a plane, so it doesn't have a right side or a wrong side necessarily with this one. So I think that's a really nice thing, because otherwise I'd be worried that I've got it the wrong way round or anything like that. So this makes this project easier in a way.
Yes, and it makes having a solid fabric, it really makes the most, I think, of the print. It really shows it off.
Mm. And that's what I think is what you want with your Tilda fabrics, isn't it?
So I'm just basting the ears on. So the front of the ears to the right side, and they just go either side of the central dot at the top.
Okay.
So I'll baste that one on.
How long does it take to make a bunny, do you think?
Because
we do it in stages, and we have certain bits, like we've had three of the paws made and things like that. Is it an afternoon or a day?
I think it's an afternoon, and then maybe spend the evening sat down doing the face and things. I don't like to hurry facial features. I like to, maybe if I'm making toys, maybe have a stack of them that need faces.
Oh, really? The faceless bundle.
There will be a faceless bunch next to me as I have a film on and just work my way through giving them each a face. Now, my tip for adding the back of the head.
Oh, that's the back of the head. You see, this is it. I wouldn't necessarily have known that was the back of the head. It's like, oh, more ears.
These are the back of head pieces. And right. I sew from the top to halfway.
Okay.
Because then I can sew the head on via the neck seam, because the whole of the head's not sealed. It'd be easier to show that, I think, than explain it. My explaining skills are not really up to scratch.
Is this why you need an interpreter for your patterns?
Yes.
I love that that's a job. If that's actually a job for
the
someone
technical editor, they make sense of them.
So hang on, the technical editor for Simply Sewing, that's Reed, isn't it?
It is, she...
Who we have on the shows.
Yes.
So that would have been her that had to make sense of the bunny.
Yes, she has to make sense of quite a few of my patterns, unfortunately. Unfortunately for Bex. So I've sewn those together just to join them, and then it means I can sew the back of the head onto the front of the head. Now, I always match up the middle and sew from the middle down out to the side and do the seam in two goes, because then you're not having to... It's not a tight curve to do, it's just a gentle curve on either side.
So little things like that make it easier, don't they?
It does just simplify it, because in my old job I had to be quick, and for me, you would think that took longer, but actually it would guarantee or much higher chance of getting it right first time.
Did you ever work sort of making these, as in sort of on a sort of conveyor belt of bunnies or?
No, I just made the prototype samples. So I would make one to keep as reference and one to send to the client. So I would make two of a design.
It's a whole different world, isn't it, of how these things work? It's ever so clever. And just to ease your way round.
Feel free to just pivot and rearrange the fabric at any point, just to keep the seam on track.
A great way to really boost your skills, I think, with this, especially if you're making something that you absolutely love, then I think this will be one that you make and love and make and love. Like you say, you make a bunny every Easter. Perfect.
Everybody needs a bunny on the shelf at Easter.
Of course they do. Of course they do. And of course, we've got a variety of Tilda fabrics for you to choose from today. So if you'd like to add the Autumn Tree Tilda Fat 8th bundle into your stash, then for $34.95, it's yours. Real beautiful spring greens throughout that. And you've got everything from your pastel pinks through to those deep strawberries and raspberries in this creation. It's just, just gorgeous. Apologies to anyone that's only just joined us. I'm afraid it's happened again. The bunnies have sold out. But here's the thing. Maybe you were one of the lucky ones that managed to get the big-eared bunny pattern. So what we're going to do is just continue to walk through how to make the bunny, because obviously so many of you now have the bunny. It's only fair that you get to see it. But if you would like to stock up on any of your Tilda fabrics, then please do. The details are on the screen for you. $34.95. Jo, we have ears.
We have ears. So at this point, I would just sew the front of the face together and then pop the ears, pop the head to one side while I...
So now you sew
deal
up
with the body.
The gullety bit.
Yep, up to the nose. It's so much easier if you demonstrate on your own body.
Well, yeah, no, yeah, you know then, don't you? Where we're going. What's been your favourite animal to make?
Oh, I don't know.
I like making bears, because actually I don't make teddy bears very often.
Oh really?
It's always, yes, it's a different animal usually. So you'd think I'd make lots of bears. I make quite a lot of mice.
Do you? Are they a favourite?
I do like mice.
And how often, sorry, I feel like I'm grilling you here. How often do you, bear grills, how often do you end up having to make these for your boys because they tell you about somebody's party and you've got a day?
Well,
no time to shop.
My youngest would not give them away. If there is a toy made, it always finds its way into his bed.
Really?
Always. Yes.
Now, last time you were on with me, you let slip a little family secret. And I love this. I absolutely love this about you. You love sewing so much, and you love your toys that you've made so much, as do your boys, that actually all of their creations have little patchwork quilts.
They do. They're in little... It's like a sleeping bag, but it has a little pillow section and a quilt. So it's a pocket, but it looks like a little patchwork bed.
Do they have them all lined up at bedtime?
No, they're just randomly scattered out. That would require them to be neat and tidy, which...
I can't say for that. I have one of those too.
Yes.
Yeah. You got to tidy, Mummy, is what I got told the other day.
Oh,
so, thanks. Yeah, maybe just don't make the mess in the first place. So, here's the bunny body.
And I've already joined the top and the bottom of the body.
Mm-hmm.
There's a marker in the middle so you can make sure the seam's
right
on track. But this length... is the same size on either side, so as long as you don't pull or stretch it, I mean, pin it first by all means, but they should fit together nicely. There's no easing or anything.
Okay.
So there's the body, and then I would I'd start with the arms. So these are the arms because they are basted closed so that the seam runs centrally down the back. And there are markers on here, so I would seam side to right side of body, and I would just baste those in place.
It just seems to help, doesn't it, having that basted in, and then you're not having to juggle pins and everything else.
They're not moving about when you come to sew the seam.
Just done. And no forward or backwards stitch to kind of...
No, it's only to hold them in place. Plus, if it's slipped and it's moved out of position, you can just take out the stitches very easily.
Yeah.
And
So I've got a little update for you. There are three left of the cream bunnies. So 0800 112 4433. If you want to go for the cream bunny, we have three left in the cream. Let me show you what that looks like. Bear with me, I'll bring it back. And we'll be back with the cream bunny in a second. I have to say, I think the cream bunny is my favourite.
I like the cream.
Love the cream. This is the cream. So you've got the bumblebee fabric there. The delicacy of the flowers, the bumblebee there, and then this is the cream body fabric, if you will. So we've got three of these left. You get your thread, you get your embroidery thread, you're also going to get your wadding and your stuffing. 0.5 metre of each of those fabrics. It's a lot.
It is a lot of fabric.
It is an awful lot of fabric that you're getting here, especially as one of those is Tilda. Gorgeous. NJGC41. If you are lucky enough to give us a quick ring, if you have missed out, 0800 112 4433. We have got, it's always worth giving us a ring because people change their mind or they change the colour option or they take it out of the basket or someone's already bought one for them. So there are three available, just three. 0800 112 4433. But the quickest three will be the ones to get it and they will be the ones calling up. 0800 112 4433. And remember, it's free to call. Hurrah!
So when the arms are basted on, you can baste the legs on at this point, but actually I'm going to add the head first because it's a little bit fiddly and I'm not juggling two more limbs. So in the middle, there's a mark, but if you just want to snip ever so slightly, when that's underneath, you then definitely know where the middle is. Plus,
okay.
It just gives it a little bit of freedom to turn. So I'll sew the head on. I'm just going to go for this. I mean, pinning.
Excellent.
Might be.
Now, Jo, earlier on, you bought us the Sew Organised box kit with the with the caravan. And we've still got stock of the owl one. We've still got a few. Yeah, we've still got a few of those left. Not very many. Okay, not very many. But if we're talking about Joe's incredibly popular designs that just go, we've got six of these left. Oh my goodness, we are down to literally the last handful here. So $27.95 for your So Organised box kit. Within that, you get six fat quarters, you get your interfacing, you get your hand sewing needles, you get your thread. You're also going to get a pattern for three different ways in which to organise yourself, but in a beautiful way.
Yes.
There you go. So back to the bunny.
When you're making the limbs, if you want to leave the top section, I always leave the top sort of half an inch-ish free of stuffing because it makes it easier to sew into the join. But the less stuffing, the easier it is to get your machine around.
If you overstuff further down, can you sort of push it back up?
You can. Give it a bit of a squidge and manipulate the filling back up to the top.
Okay. Is that a technical term?
A squidge. Yes.
Yeah, no, I'm happy with a squidge.
You say something confidently enough, people.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Yeah, so, yeah, it's a squidge.
Yeah, give it a squidge, but everybody knows exactly what you mean.
It does the job. So then we've got the head onto the body. And then I would base the legs in place.
And you could already start to see. Yeah, so this is where I have to really think about things. Is basting the legs in, they've got to be flipped up, haven't they? This is where it all feels really strange when you baste them in.
Flipped up that way.
Looks like it's doing gymnastics.
High kicking?
Yes.
And the seams, it's not the end of the world if they're not in the right place, but I like to have the seams facing inwards.
Right.
So I'll baste those on and then...
It's like a can-can bunny at this stage.
It is.
We have got one of the bunnies left. So, of the blue. We've got one of the blue left. Okay. I think people have changed their mind on the colour. So, $19.95 gives you the blue, which is this one that we're working with. JMGC14 and three of the cream, $19.95. NJGC14. Always do give us a call, because you never know. You never know.
You never, never, never do. Right. I can see my own markers. You might have. I'm confident both legs. Although the way things have been going for me this week, I'm confident I've put the legs in the correct position.
Yeah, not going to be coming out his nose or anything. That's fine. Basic bunny anatomy. It's all good.
So once we get to that stage, there's only the base to add at this point because the tail's hand stitched on at the end.
Right.
Now, the base, it says in the pattern to, and this is the way I would do it, but when I was thinking about it, I thought this is quite tricky. So you want to, the centre of the back, put it in a seam allowance width, and then sew from there around, it goes around this join. But because you have limbs and things, it does make it a little bit awkward. So I would sew the whole base on and leave an opening in the back to stuff the bunny.
Mm.
But I have this one here. I've pinned so you can see. If you want to sew from the back round over the legs so the legs are properly sandwiched in place and stop there, you could close the bunny there. Let's turn it all. Pop all these bits and pieces inside. Stuff his arms in his head.
He's like a contortionist, isn't he? Stuff everything in your bunny.
And then you could sew. We'll keep those out of the opening. From the back of the head, you could sew the back closed.
So it's only...
And leave the opening in the base if the base was getting a bit much to sew on. And his legs need to poke out of the bottom. I tend to sew the whole and leave the whole base on and leave the opening in the back. But it's what you find...
It's up to you, isn't it?
Yeah, it's more comfortable.
So this is why you say this is an intermediate project, because there are these little fiddlier bits that you just take your time with, make sure that don't sew the limbs, you know, just make sure that you've got enough space and you've pushed everything in.
Yes.
But do give us a call just to check stock, because you never know, there might be one left. I think there's one in the blue left, $19.95. JMGC14. Has a pink one come back as well? There might be a pink one as well. But do always check. Just give us a call, 0800 112 4433, because you never know. never know.
It's worth a try, isn't it?
Yes, isn't it? Absolutely.
So I'll just sew the base on now, and then I'll hastily move on to the face and the...
Which is the hardest bit to do with this? Is it the face? Is it this bit?
It's this bit.
This bit.
Yes. I would say so. And if you have the needle down function on your machine... See, I wouldn't do this with pins.
What would you... How?
I just go for it, because I've made a few and I know... Yeah. So actually, I've made life slightly more difficult for myself in that this is not the way I would normally do it. And I'm quite clumsy and I always catch myself on pins.
Please be careful. Please be careful. We didn't risk assess your show. Now, there's one more book on the show that we haven't shown you yet, and that's The Homemade and Happy. Now, this is by Tony Fananga. See, I said that with confidence. Not quite sure if that's how it's pronounced, but we'll go with that. It is now 13.95, and this is your Homemade and Happy. Again, just beautiful, beautiful ideas. That is, I believe, her own log cabin. But just, again, it's Tilda, isn't it? So it's quirky, it's shabby chic, it's, achingly beautiful all the way through. So whether you're... Well, I mean, this has got a Christmas element to it, but... all sorts of other gift ideas in there as well. Look at that. But you see, look, that could be... doesn't have to be a reindeer. Could just be a lovely toy. And you've got in here the quilt. Oh, look at the owls. I knew they were all... There you go. There's They're owls cute. For you. And those. Then that's the quilt. I love that quilt.
Wow.
All in there. Oh...
They're adorable.
Is this the one? This has got the pig in there as well. There, your pig on wheels. Everybody needs a pig on wheels.
Do you want the truth?
Yeah.
I like people to tell me what to make.
Oh, really?
I like to work from... sorry, excuse me. From someone else's idea, I really like. I really like to be... Somebody say,
can you make this? So someone gives you a brief.
Yes.
And then what happens if they don't then?
I start with an idea and I think, oh, that's really good, I'll start doing that. And then halfway through I think, oh, no, I don't want to do it like this. I might do a different animal. So I'll stop and then change it to a different animal. And then I never get anywhere with it because I've just changed it.
But if you've got...
They so easily look like cows. No matter what you do. I think I've cracked it now, but I've spent a lot of time trying to de-cow a
Many
horse.
A horse. Yeah.
There's something about the width of the face.
In all his glory, this is what we're making. So you get everything that you need in the bundle, even down to the thread and the wadding and the stuffing, the whole lot. I mean, this is an incredible bundle for $19.95. NJGC41. This is why we can't keep him in stock, quite frankly. And why he just flies every single time. But if you are after, please do just give us a call, because you never know. 0800 112 4433, because he might have bounced back. He's that kind of a bunny.
There we go. That's all the machine sewing done.
And then you just stitch up, well, stuff, obviously.
I would stuff the face, and then you can go in through the back. And with your embroidery needle, so you could tie a knot in the end of your thread and the knot's held inside in the filling, and then you can stitch your face. Drawing it on first with an air erasable or a water erasable pen's great. It's a good way of making sure you get it right first time, to have guidelines to follow. And then I use these seams to form the nose and then just pop a little smile underneath.
This is gorgeous. There's no two ways about it. Now, the tail.
The tail.
Let's talk tails. Two, we are fully ready for the tail.
I have a tail and a spare ready to go.
Love how organised you are. Spare tail. Everyone should have a spare tail.
What will become of the spare tail there after this?
I don't know, because we've got two to finish, haven't we?
So, using the same seam allowance again. Just
now, did you quilt? You've quilted this. In fact, if I just show that... Because you've got your wadding on there, then you can just see, look, can you see the quilting? So a great first quilting project, actually.
It is, there's just little bits of quilting involved in it. It does
just give you a little. I like that, just a little bit of extra detailing for the bunny. And
it's extra texture, isn't it?
It is, and however you quilt that is, you know, unique to that bunny.
Yes. Oh, yes. Do you find that, though, with every toy that you make, each one is different? Each one is just...
It's really difficult to make two exactly the same, because it's something you only have to change the... do a slightly different face, and it can completely change the look. So it's hard to make identical twins.
Okay.
Even the cats yesterday had little sort of different looks to them.
Little looks. I saw those actually when we came in. They were set on the desk when I came in. Really sweet, really sweet. So if you've managed to grab the bunny today, then a big congratulations to you. If you want to grab more Tilda fabric so that you can keep making all these goodies and keep them authentic in this beautiful fabric, absolutely gorgeous. And we've got the books for you as well. Basically, go and have a look on the website, www.sewingquarter.com. Take a look underneath where the live feed of the show is. There's everything that we've used on the shows today. They're all down there. The books are on there, or the patterns that we've used today. Your homemade and happy book, which was this one. This is the one with the pig on wheels.
I might have to have a look at the pig on wheels.
Shall I show you the pig on wheels? You get all the full patterns in the back.
I really like, I've never used that technique.
Oh, look at that one now as well.
Tilda, there's a specific way that toys are made, and I've never done it like that before, where you draw on the lines to follow when you sew. And it's a great way of...
What am I going to need for this? I wonder if you could use your fat eights with that. What do you think? Could you make a small one out of your fat eights?
Oh, I think you could.
That would be a bit stunning, wouldn't it? Hang on, where... Oh, hello. You've got
Wow.
Yeah, no, there's so much in there. Where's the pig gone? Where's the pig on wheels gone? I've lost my pig on wheels. He's towards the back, isn't he? I do believe.
I keep an eye out. I've just done a running stitch all the way around the outside, back to the start, and then just gather it up before it's fully closed. Pop stuffing in there, and then tighten it right up. Imagine this stuffing in there.
Yeah.
And push the raw edges to the inside.
Okay.
And then don't snip away the thread, and then you can sew it onto the back of the bunny once it's closed. But go round, sort of taking some from the tail down to the back of the bunny, and go round twice just for extra added security.
Okay.
So this
because
would,
that's
going to
be the thing, isn't
stuff.
It, that gets pulled off?
Yes. So you want to make sure twice around should really hold it in place.
Should do the job.
Yes.
Jo, thank you so much. I found you your pig on wheels.
Oh, let me know. Look, his little rosy cheeks and everything.
Oh, he's fabulous. And even down to the detail of his tail.
Hmm.
Maybe you could make us a pig, Jo.
I think I want to now. I think I...
Oh, yeah. If you want to grab your Autumn Tree Fat 8 bundle so that you two can be making pigs and all sorts of goodies and, oh, beautiful things, then do grab that, $34.95. Jo, thank you.
Once again,
sell-out show. Gosh. But like I say, if you're after anything, please do give us a call. Free phone number 0800 112 4433. When are you back? And what are you bringing us?
I'm not altogether sure yet, but it's a week on Friday.
Cutting it a little bit close then.
Well, no, I do generally know, but I'm not completely...
You haven't made it yet then.
No, I've not made it. I know what... Yeah.
Excellent.
Good. A week on Friday, I've got
time. Loads of time. You could have made an entire warren of bunnies by then, couldn't you?
I could.
These are just beautiful. Thank you so much. And thank you at home today for watching. Gosh, what a day. Have we got any other caravans left, or have they all gone now as well? Couple of the caravans left. If you're after the caravans, then please do go and grab that. If you are watching again, then please just give us a call, because check your stock levels. Just fabulous. We are going to be back 8 o'clock tomorrow, 8 till 12, live. So do join us then. What a day.
And a busy one.
Yeah, I want to make one of those jackets.
Oh, I love
yeah.
those jackets.
Check out the jackets. So, yeah, do watch again. You can watch again online or you can watch again on YouTube. We will see you first thing tomorrow morning. Have a wonderful rest of the day. Thank you ever so much. See you later. Bye-bye.
Sewing Quarter is at the very heart of sewing as we bring you all things sewing and quilting. The team behind us live and breathe sewing day to day. We strive to bring you exclusive offers, exciting live demonstrations, and most importantly, we will custom cut fabric to your specification in our very own cutting room. We will also be bringing you TV exclusives that you won't be able to find anywhere else. So come and join us today at the Sewing Quarter.
Welcome to the Sewing Quarter!